Point, Michigan. Your ass is listening to Radio Underground. Shit.
Radio Underground, episode 47. We are going to talk about, well, it's the last one episode we're going to do before Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
And thanks for joining me again. Al and Brian, hello, guys.
Hey.
All right. That was stereo there.
I was, like, waiting for him to do it, and I think he's waiting for me.
Yeah, the Mothra twins.
Hey.
Or triplets. I'm sorry there was three. I always get it wrong.
Merry Christmas.
We just had a Christmas song play.
Tomorrow's the first day of Hanukkah.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yes.
Why is it so late this year?
You know, it's Jewish calendar, man. I don't know.
The River Bottom Nightmare band song was a cover by my brother-in-law and show contributor, Stones Malone.
Yes.
Just in the nick of time, he sent over the file. I'm like, hey, would you by chance have that file of that? You can send it over so I can use it. And he sent it, so that's good.
That's perfect. That's a Christmas song. That's cool.
I got all my shopping done.
I have none of my shopping done.
I got Amazon, so
yeah.
I shouldn't say shopping. Yeah. I pointed and clicked.
Yeah, kind of. Like, I actually had to go into the store and pick up something, and then they didn't have everything I ordered, so they shipped the rest of it. And it showed up on time, so.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
I bought my bass today, but I didn't get my keyboard yet. So,
what kind of bass did you get?
It's just an Ibanez with the package with the little tiny amp. I mean, it's a super small amp to fit in that box.
I figured it was small. Yeah. It was on the box.
Yeah. But it's an Ibanez 4-string, black, you know, just standard.
I think I want to get a Schecter 4-string. They're a nice economical 4-string that sounds good.
Yeah, I just bought the kit because the kit was like $200 and something bucks, you know, and so.
It comes with like a pocket amp.
Yeah. I mean, it fits in the pocket. Nah, it's a little bigger in the pocket, but not much.
Yeah.
So it had like headphones with it and everything. I'm like.
Yeah, I don't know. I sold all my equipment, every amp, every guitar, everything. But the one piece of equipment I wish I would have kept, I had a real nice Jackson with EMGs.
Yeah.
Guitar, even though I'm not really a guitar player or bass, it's the one I regret because it sounded so good. And I'd have guitar players come over and play it and like, would you pay for that? I'm like, I think I paid $250 for it used.
Yeah.
And like, the thing sounds great, dude.
Holy crap.
They would just rip on it. And I had the Floyd Rose block because I'm not a lead player at all.
Mm-hmm.
But even like the guys, they would play leads on it and it would hold. He goes, you got the Floyd Rose block and it still can jam on this thing. I'm like, yeah. And my dad blocked it. I didn't.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know how to do anything.
No. you just said things.
That requires
like,
a wrench.
I've heard Floyd Rose before. You said other things. I was like, yeah, I don't know that.
Floyd Rose, man.
It's just so you can do dive bombs without sending your shit out of tune.
Oh. Okay.
But
dive bombs, yeah.
And for regular tuning, they're a pain in the ass. If you're not a lead player and you don't need it, so you just, I don't know, remove the fucking thing.
Right.
I didn't need it. You know, Eddie Van Halen and Dimebag Darrell need it, but not me.
No. You're not those guys.
No. I'm not even a regular guitar player. I'm not even good by regular standards at guitar. I'm a bass player by trade.
Well, my son got a guitar for his birthday that actually Alan bought him, and he's been practicing for a few days, like an hour at a time, and that's about amazing. 75 times better than I ever was on guitar. So
yeah, it's been what, 4 days?
It's been like four days. Yeah,
he's mastered it.
He's way better than me. So
yeah,
hey man, I picked up a bass first time in like, I don't know, 15 years since I've touched one, since I picked up anybody's, and I still remember the beginning of, well, it's super easy, but Black Number One by Type.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
and then I still remember the one, Clutch, Big News, Part One. It's all do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. I know that still. I was like, oh, wow, I haven't touched this in 15 years. I still remember the two things I learned on the bass 20 years ago.
A good bass line to show people, something that you'll hear on the radio and people identify it and get that. Oh, I knew it was Hey Man, Nice Shot by Filter.
It's
a pretty easy bass line. It's all done on one string.
Yeah, right.
It's all done on the whole thing. And the bass line doesn't change throughout the whole song. No. It's the same thing, verse, chorus, everything. It's just one.
Like you can put that CD and knock it down and shut everything else out, and that bass line just never.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not as simple. It's a little more, if you want to get a little more difficult. But even cooler song, Wood by Alice in Chains.
Yeah.
When I learned to play that, I thought it was badass. Like, dude, I got it, man. I understand. I get the bass.
I don't know, but I want to learn how to play, Enter Sandman on the bass. Like, doo 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 doo. I don't know why. I just feel this need that I want.
I never learned that.
I really can't stand that song. It's really, one of the songs I do not like by Metallica.
I never learned it. Even though I loved that song for years,
yeah.
I never did learn that bass line. I probably should know it, but I don't.
I don't know. I kind of want to learn that one. I just hear I just want to sit in my room and play it.
Yeah. Well, the first thing I learned was Come As You Are.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And Jay Harris showed me that.
Yeah, I do know that one.
The legendary biker finger.
Yeah.
He showed me. But, yeah.
I forgot I know that.
Yeah,
he wrote a new song, I guess, to put it on his YouTube page, or on his son's YouTube page. It's called Black Dildo for Christmas.
Why am I not surprised? our band, Skarnak, is like comedy rock or offensive rock based off of Jay, really.
Really, it was.
He was kind of like what he did first and showed him. We thought it was funny.
Not very produced by Biker Finger.
Yeah.
No. Yeah, so I still one day before I die, I want to play Biker Finger, the anthem with them.
Yeah.
Like, we'll have a whole band. We all just get up there with all their instruments, do the whole thing. Doom, da doom, doom.
Yep.
Joe the Master.
Biker Finger.
Raise your finger.
Brian, I have bad news to tell you.
Yeah.
I wrote this down because someone put on the YouTube page, and someone in my Slack group. I know you're not going to want to hear this. So the one guy kind of sounds like Brendan Schaub.
Dude, I read that earlier. I saw him like, who are they talking about, me?
But there's a guy in my Slack group guy that put it this way. He goes, he sounds like Brendan Schaub if Brendan Schaub were smart.
Okay.
So it's not that bad.
Well, thank you. I read it earlier.
Shout out to Smith. He's the one that said it.
One of the comments when I was doing some of the YouTube stuff earlier, and I saw him like, who the hell are they talking about? And I didn't know if it was me or not. I was like, wow.
I'm not just saying it because I don't kind of see it that way. The only thing is that we all kind of have nasally voices from allergies or something. But I don't think you sound like Shop to me.
Well, you know? I will take it as he could kick everybody's ass around us. So I'm like, yeah, I guess I'm like Brendan Schaub.
Yeah.
So he's a UFC fighter.
He used to be. Now he's a... And he's a podcaster and comedian.
And he's friends with, Rogan and...
Okay.
What's up, Benetration?
That comedian thing was in quotes, because he's not very funny.
No, he's not.
Okay.
His stand-up was awful.
He's decent on his podcast.
Yeah, that's true.
He can be funny at times, but...
That stand-up special...
The stand-up was really bad.
Wow.
He's not a bad interviewer. There's some certain things he does well, but he should have never, ever... Not done a stand-up special. I'm sorry.
That was so bad.
Podcast. He's fine on the podcast, but whatever.
Is he just on The Fighter and the Kid, or is he do the other one too? Him and
See, I don't know. The YouTube one, a lot of times Callan's not there, so it leads me to think he has his own thing.
Him and Theo.
Theo, yeah, and then he does The Fighter and the Kid. It's like has been his main thing forever.
Yeah,
but I don't know. I don't know what is.
Callan tours a lot, so
yeah, maybe it is Fighter and the Kid. He's just gone, and Theo and those guys just come fill in the slot. I don't know.
Theo doesn't have a real job, so he doesn't tour.
No, yeah, you see the thing with him and Burr, where Bill Burr was kind of shitting on him.
No, I didn't. But
same thing. Bill Burr did the same thing to Ethan Klein from what do they call it? H3H3 or something like that. H1N1. I don't know. It's It's a guy and his wife. They have a pretty big YouTube channel, and they used to do. I should know it, but I don't. I'm not being funny. I don't really know their.
I don't.
But his name's Ethan Klein. I know that much, and I forgot her name. Anyways, they basically, it's kind of like a Rogan thing where they bring different people in and different types of guests. And anyway, Bill Burr shit on him, and then a week later, Theo Von. So Theo Von had Ethan Klein on the show, and they were both having a therapy session about how Burr treated them both really bad.
Dude, Bill Burr could be,
did they try to get back at Burr, or they realized that was a futile attempt?
Well, no, they didn't. They were just didn't. I think they're for, you know, because they're younger or whatever. They're not used to that old style, like the older comedian just bust your balls and shits on you.
That's him.
And he's going to shit on you if he senses any kind of weakness. You're going to get shit on. And you're just going to get it. Like if he were in here right now, he would just tear us up.
Oh,
he would tear us a new ass.
And I would appreciate it.
You guys are amateurs. Like, I know that's what would happen.
You know what? You know, and I wouldn't care one bit.
No, I would just laugh.
Because he was on the Chappelle show doing the racial draft, man. I mean, that was...
Oh, yeah. It's classic.
Dude, I mean, that right there alone, like, I mean, and I've watched him just destroy people. And then, yeah, when he talks about it, like his uncle that like gets berated by his aunt all his life, and then has a fucking stroke and can't get up and walk away from her anymore.
Yeah,
and just sits there, and he's like, and the look on his face is like, any day you want to take my life, please do. You know, but the look on his face is like priceless. You know, like his stand up is.
So Ben wants to know. So is Al a regular addition to the show? Yeah, he's been here like 6 or 7 times in a row. So I guess yes.
I like it.
Yeah, he's hired.
I like it. So
I pay.
You know,
I pay him in coffee.
Yeah, I work during the week, and you know, I got a great Christmas gift yesterday.
It was awesome.
Really awesome.
You got a ham?
I got a ham. Got a 10.5-pound ham.
Yep.
And well, my boss owns a vineyard, and so instead of a cash bonus like he usually gives everybody, he gave all of us a bottle of wine.
Yeah, he's a recovering alcoholic.
Yeah,
here's a bottle of wine.
Recovering alcoholic who had 993 days sober at that point. Well, let's give him a bottle of wine.
You know,
it wasn't that, because you know the dude's worth like $50 million. He don't remember that I'm like, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
But the look on my boss, the supervisor's face, because he was about 30 feet away when the owner came up and handed me the bottle and said, Merry Christmas. And then he turned around, and I held the bottle up. I'm like, woo-hoo! My boss, like, the look on his face, he's like, oh, comes over, I can't believe he did that. I go, why can't you believe it? The guy don't really know me from anybody else, you know? I go, I can't believe that he's cheap and gives me a bottle of his cheap, crappy wine. You know, but okay.
I was only concerned for the ham.
Yeah, the ham.
Make sure the ham is safe.
Yeah, he buys the straight up the good hams too.
Yeah, it's a good ham.
Winters. Yeah, they're good. But yeah, so that was like, that was awesome. I made sure I texted a bunch of people.
Yeah, he did right away. He's like, my boss just gave me a bottle of wine for Christmas. I'm like, what?
Oh, yeah. That's great.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm all depressed because at my work there, like, for our Christmas gift, we get told that we have to work more.
Yeah. Your gift is you get to spend more time with us.
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad, but we're going to, for a while, we're probably, I mean, it's not like, compared to what the hours you pull right now, we're going to be doing 50s or something.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, for a while. But
I
wouldn't care if I didn't have to lift all fucking day. If it was like a desk or something. Actually, that might be worse because you're just sitting there.
Yeah. It is worse.
I might suck start my Mossberg. I don't know.
I mean, like, I don't, I mean, there's heavy work. Like, there's, like, gears that I make that are, you know, I mean, huge, you know, 3 feet in diameter, you know, but we lift them with cranes. You know?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, but I don't lift anything. Like, I've gotten to the point where I don't lift anything real heavy at all anymore. I will not do it.
Yep.
You know, I get a crane to do it.
Well, yeah.
Phil says Al is the greatest, makes up for how shitty Brian is. You can respond to that, Brian.
It's because Frank's not here. All of a sudden, Brian's the shitty.
All of a sudden, it's got to go towards somebody.
Yeah.
I'm the host, so I just kind of get ignored. I'm just a conduit to whoever else is here.
I'm the odd man out in this situation. Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. Ben says, as an alcoholic that is not recovering, I approve. Well, good. Congratulations on your non-recovery.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ben. I'm proud of you, too. I'm proud of me. I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
I am. I mean, the one thing I say is I'm not bragging. I knew what I had to do for me. You know, I really did.
Oh, you got it. Yeah.
I had to. I mean, and a lot of people don't realize, like, the extent of how bad it really was. I was pretty good at high. I was just, hey, I'm just party guy. No. There was a lot more.
Everyone does that. And I know a lot of other people that are that way. Unfortunately, there's like, yeah, it's party. It's a good time. It's all about the party. And then, like, when you talk to them alone, like, dude, you need to stop.
Yeah.
Right, you know, right, like, you say that and they're kind of not wanting to hear it. See, like with you though, you were never like angry. You were never an angry drunk.
Not usually, no.
So I never really had a, except for the enough time.
Enough.
Yeah, and
enough.
I remember that time. There were.
But
you
weren't angry. You were just.
I was not really. When I was young, I was not really good with tequila.
Yeah.
Yeah, like when I'd start doing tequila, like, and it just, you know, lose it, and then I'm like stomping off somewhere and nobody could find me and they're driving around drunk looking for me.
Yeah.
You know?
See, I was never a violent drunk either, but I got to a certain level that, like, when I drink, and it'll still happen when I drink, if I get to a certain point, I get where I can passionately take both sides of every argument and then just be, then I'm surprised, but basically no one's ever knocked me out.
Right.
It's just the way I just, like, argue with everybody or kick everybody out of my... I did the Doyle Hargraves like 3 times here in this house. Everybody get out! I did the whole thing. You know, you snap at everybody. So I'm surprised no one's ever beat the fuck
out
of me.
Was that when they broke your countertop?
Yeah, they broke my $3 countertop that really...
I would have went off on that, though, too.
But,
yeah.
Yeah, it was... I told them to stop like 4 times and they didn't. Then all of a sudden I see it come out of the wall.
Smash.
Well, at first they knocked over.
You're like, stop.
Yeah, well, at first they knocked over a bunch of bottles and broke them. I didn't even yell. I'm like, guys, stop the arm wrestling on this counter, please, because you're knocking shit over and you're too old. Somebody's gonna get hurt.
You're like, enough.
Then all of a sudden they went again, and then the fucking thing ripped out of the wall, and I turned into Doyle Hargraves. Like, everybody out! You get out! And
you're enough!
Yep. Ben says, seriously, I'm proud of you for recognizing you need to change.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
I love you, brother. Good.
Cool, man. But anyway.
Yeah, this shit's getting boring. Let's talk about something cool.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah,
let's talk about depressing stuff. It's a holiday.
It's fucking the holidays, Phil. You know. And so,
don't want
to
talk about
I had to share my Christmas present story.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I bought myself some cool Christmas presents.
So. You did. Yeah.
Yeah, you got the 4-string bass.
I got a bass. Got a keyboard on the way.
Keyboard's on the way, yeah.
I'm going to start getting my Corey Hart cover band ready.
You know what I saw? We were in Guitar Center today because I took him up there to pick the stuff up. Do you know what I saw when I was there, Mike?
What?
Roadcaster Pro.
Yeah. Well, I had to pay for my hospital pro.
Yeah.
I got to pay for that first.
Yeah.
But after I do that. Because the end game is to get that item.
Well, now that we're becoming hit YouTubers, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I was like,
you know, once the checks start rolling in from all... You know,
monetize.
What I want to do, like, honestly, I'm trying to find a way to set up, like, a permanent... when I get that, to where I don't have to move, you know, set up mics and everything. So one of these rooms will be basically... I don't have, because unplugging and plugging and plugging back in is why I wore out the, you know, you wear out.
That's why we don't have headphones now, yeah.
And it just, over time, it just fucks shit up. And if you just leave it plugged in, it basically works forever.
I figured out the perfect thing to do. You need to build an addition off the back of your house.
Just
do that.
Studio, I mean. Well, the YouTube money, you know, the whole Radio Underground money should be coming in, right? You know?
Yeah, it's going to happen.
Yeah.
We're going to make the money.
And then just, you know.
Did you see that, who the richest YouTuber is? Did you see it, Mike?
No, who is it?
The person who made the most money off of YouTube is an 8-year-old named Ryan.
From Ryan's World?
Yep. Yeah. He made $26 million.
Well, that classifies him as rich.
Yeah.
Because, well, it used to be.
They're talking about your large penis, Al, now. Okay. I don't know how it's moved on to that.
Yeah, Ryan's World kid made 26. That makes him number one. Dude Perfect is number two at with 20 million.
Well, I know that like about a decade ago, in order to be classified as rich, you had to be worth $26.2 million. Now, this was pre-recession, though, so that might have been even 15 years ago.
So you're not rich at 25 mil, huh?
No. No, you're not classified as rich.
Was that just wealthy?
That was
wealthy?
At that point. You were extremely wealthy on the verge of rich.
Yeah. Because $26.2 million
was the key number.
I wonder why, though.
That's weird.
I had no idea.
Does that mean like you can pretty much buy? I don't. Yeah.
I just read it, and one day I thought, well, if I was worth like $24.5 million, I'd just tell people I'm not rich.
Al, do you get lightheaded when it gets hard? That's a question.
Who's asking these questions?
Do I get
Phil and Ben?
Do I get lightheaded?
We used to call him horse cock.
No,
I remember that. Actually, I do remember that moniker.
Lightheaded when I... No, I don't know, dude. I haven't had a boner in a long time.
Yeah.
I don't have sex with women anymore either. I'm celibate.
He's celibate.
Turned into a monk.
Yeah.
I was celibate for 2.5 days.
It's all, you know, it's all...
So,
it's all for the greater good.
For the greater good.
The greater
for the
good.
Greater good. Yeah, for the good.
What was I going to say?
I'm going to quit doing all this talking about dicks because sending me to my grave with AIDS.
I do not want to have a conversation about my dick or how I lose
consciousness.
Lose consciousness when I get a boner.
You guys, it's giving me AIDS. Thanks for sending me to my grave with AIDS.
Yep.
For sure.
Yeah, I'm not arrogant at all. I do drops of my own voice.
Some people do that.
Yeah. Yeah, those are.
I can't believe Phil.
It's kind of, you know.
Why should someone be gay?
When you talk about someone's dick, that's when you should be gay. But, yeah, I don't know, man. I think, though, that Al's cock has been talked about for many years. And
yeah,
it's kind of a boring subject to me because
I've
had many conversations about it. Him and Jeffrey from Hillbilly Havoc, he's another one, supposedly big.
That's the rumor.
Yeah. So Jeff has supposedly made women tap out, I've heard. I don't know. My Uncle Wink, same thing.
Hey, my favorite thing was this girl, Dawn, that told me I ruined her for every guy after me. And she literally said that to me. I'm like, oh, okay.
That must have made you feel awful.
That made me feel so bad.
So bad for people.
Yeah.
I never told anybody that afterward.
Yeah.
Every single chance I got.
Yeah, there's a big difference between them not being able to handle it and then not being able to handle laughing at it. There's kind of a you don't want to be on that end of it. You want them to be afraid of it.
See, now, but I've been told if you don't use it, you lose it.
Can confirm.
I don't know. We'll find out.
Yeah, I can confirm that. It's the truth.
You just got to eat clean diet like I do.
Yeah, clean diet. Yeah. Clean pizza.
Yep. The pizza wasn't that greasy.
Clean tortilla.
The Slim Jim was
tortilla chips.
Very healthy taquitos I had yesterday.
Yeah.
I forgot what I was going to say now.
Clean diet?
Nope. That wasn't it. I had something else. Fuck you, Phil.
Yeah,
That was it. Every 5 minutes, I got to remind the world, fuck you, Phil. I don't know what I did to him, but...
Ben, I ain't gay, and I ain't headed that way, but if I was in prison, I would want to be in a cell with Mike. See, it's my lips. I got these big, full lips. That's what does it. I'm telling
what it is?
Yeah. Everyone thinks I can suck.
Is that what it is, Ben?
Yeah. It's got to be the full lips. Been told this before. You know how people, like,
you don't want to be in prison with me, Ben, because, I'm going to hit bottom?
Yeah.
I'm going to bury it.
Oh, well, because Hal's been there. He knows the...
Yeah. I know how to get a lot of shit done in prison, man.
Yeah. He's got all the hookups.
Gross.
Hey, man. I know where I got a lot of hookups.
You know, the thing that's kind of... Remember, it's the 21st. Remember like 7 years ago, everybody thought the world was going to end this day?
Yeah.
And it was a big thing. And and then afterwards, well, it's not that it's going to end. It's that it's not going to be the same from here on. Like, people always move the goalposts.
It's just like the Heaven's Gate and all the other people.
It was like, what, like almost 20 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
2K.
Everything was supposed to collapse.
Yeah, the
in 10 days from now, it'll be 20 years.
I like how they're talking about all the geniuses, like 150, 160 IQ people that designed all our power grids and everything. They didn't think of like, oh, after it turned from 1999 to 2000, nothing's going to work anymore. They didn't foresee that.
No. Yeah.
this guy's, they have like the smartest people in the world that build these things. They didn't think of that.
Right.
Of that decimal becoming
a two.
I just remember all the people that like, I mean, like basements, like years later, like I was married to Angel at the time, and her dad had a basement full of just like doomsday supplies, dude. Oh. Like everything you could think of, because he was convinced we were done. He never used bank. He would go straight to the bank, cash his check, get his money. He was no computers, no nothing. He's like, he goes, see, I told you. And I'm like, dude, it's
yeah,
not
but if it's the
crash.
End and it's a collapse of the economy and the world, was you know it, your money's not worth anything
anyway.
It's
not going to crash, man. He's like, I don't care. He was stocked. Yeah. Wow. He was stocked. His basement, he was ready.
Yeah.
It was like 4 years later, there's still like tons of bottles of water. And
well, I was kind of into that thinking about preparedness and like bug out shelters. And I was like, well, I could save up and I could do that, but then I listened to a special forces guy on a podcast like lay out like years ago. He kind of like 3-4 years ago, he like laid out like different scenarios where doomsday type things had happened.
Yeah.
And if you live 7 miles even from a country road, every house within 7 miles got totally ransacked, and those homeowners and stuff had firearms and everything, but you're not going to be, it's not like what's that fucking movie we've talked about, the show, the zombie TV show.
Oh, Walking Dead.
Walking Dead, where it's just like gangs of 12. No, it's thousands.
Yeah.
Thousands of people are going to fucking come to your, and if you can't fend off thousands.
Yeah, right.
You're fucked.
Right.
Yep. So it's like,
dude. It ain't like seven people are walking up to your house going, oh, dear. Yeah, right.
Yeah, because like Weimar Germany and all that and different things that have happened over the years and Russia and China, when the food runs out, I think it's within a week, the average person becomes criminal. Within 14 or 15 days, they become a fucking cannibal when they're desperate. So, like, I'd rather die than fight.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you could have yourself a little preparedness, whatever, but, yeah, I mean.
I mean, if you have a true place, like, there are places you can be, like, where there's high ground. And people aren't likely to go, and if you strategically map it out that way. But this guy basically said, if like you're thinking you're like your cabin, hunting cabin up north, is gonna be safe or something, you're fucking stupid.
Yeah, right.
You know,
yeah.
he kind of woke me up to. I'm like, you know what?
Yeah.
he said the best thing you can do is have enough food in your house to last about 2 weeks, because even like during a coup or something, some sort of order kind of comes in a couple weeks.
Yeah.
The years long of hell thing is, it can happen, but that's an act of war. And when you got an act of actual, like a world war, such,
yeah,
nothing you can do anyway. You know?
No.
Like, right.
You can have all the canned corn in the world. It's not going to make a difference.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
So Uncle Mike's advice is when it goes bad, kids, give up.
Yeah.
Just quit.
That's what I tell my kids.
Just lay in a corner and die.
Just have 2 weeks worth of food and then, a shotgun for afterward. Yeah.
Save a bullet for yourself.
Yeah, save a bullet.
they always told that to pioneers, so you don't get caught by the Indian. Save a bullet for yourself.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
That's all I'm saying. Phil, I had a ref tell me last week he was shitting the bed with terrible calls, and he blew an offsides and led to the game-winning goal in OT. You're blaming the ref for your failures, by the way.
Yeah. Did that affect your plus-minus?
He came to the bench to explain how he sucked so bad. I told him, find a new hobby. He promptly said, fuck you, Phil. See, I like this ref.
So wait, the ref actually came over and confessed how shit he was doing or how bad Phil was.
He said to explain how come he sucked so bad. Basically, probably like, hey, guys, sorry I missed that call.
Oh.
But Phil, in his infinite rage and hatred, told him to get a new hobby. And he
it's
said,
just
fuck
a game,
you, Phil.
It's just a game.
It's not that big of a deal. I don't know. I would. Yes, he did.
Was it the championship?
Was it the championship game, Phil? Was it that important? Did you have to get that mad about nothing?
Probably.
Yeah. Winning's the only thing that matters.
I guess
it
so.
Is. That's true.
Yeah.
That is true. Yeah. Winning is everything.
I guess if you're gonna do something, you want to win, but
I don't know. I just like always like look at it this way. You know, I have the Bri approach to it. Bri's like, do you really want to be a loser?
Yeah.
No. Bri's like, dude, Bri was like the best pitcher in like the Tri-County area back when he was in his teens, and he pitched a almost perfect game. He was basically one strike from a perfect game in a championship, and his dad was the coach, and his dad told him he didn't pitch good enough.
Well, that's terrible parenting.
And Bri's like, see, because I failed.
I bet it made him good, though.
He's like, oh, yeah. He's like, see, I was a loser, even though we won. He's like, he goes, I missed that one strike for a perfect game.
Well, I had two coaches basically growing up, my dad and then the guy that was all the way across the street from
right,
me.
Right.
So yeah. They knew me, and they both felt comfortable treating me like dog shit.
Right.
So it was like,
we know like they wanted to win.
Yeah, Ron was even worse than my dad though. We would win by 30 and be like, anybody can beat these guys by 30. Yeah. Anyone.
Yeah,
right. Jesus Christ, we killed these guys.
That was when they actually that was when they let the games actually get run up that bad. Now
yeah, right.
They don't do it.
Yeah. Yeah, he was
there's no mercy. Yeah.
He was miserable. Even if we won all the time, he was still mad.
Yeah.
He's like, pretty soon you're going to face somebody you can't beat. Like, we won the whole season.
Imagine being his son then.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
Well, his son was, funny thing is, Bobby, I saw him 2 days ago.
Did you really?
And here's what happened. He's back in town right now from, he flew out to Vegas to see Kevin.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then his girlfriend has a place in Arizona, so he was out west. And Saturday he comes up to me. He's like, "Hey, Mike, could you grab my mail for me? And just you know, because I'm going to be gone for a week." I said, "Yeah, Saturday is Saturday." I said, "Yeah, sure." Well, I kind of noticed. I think it was like Thursday night. I saw like a water coming down from like glistening in his driveway under the moonlight. I'm like, because he has like different workers there because he's older, like. Like, did he get his fucking house power washed or something? I don't know. But, it's an afterthought. Well, the next day, my dad noticed that it was bigger. My dad couldn't get in his house because we didn't have a key. Long story short, his furnace, quit.
Oh.
And then the pipe burst because it got down to 12 degrees. And it is just thrashed in there. And his son, Bobby, came over, saw me in the morning. He's like, dude, he goes, the whole house is just wrecked.
Oh, my God. It sucks.
So Ron's not been on vacation since his wife passed away.
Yo. The first time he goes.
First time he goes on a vacation. His furnace happened to quit on an unusual cold night. Like, it got down to 12 degrees,
yeah,
and it fucking broke his pipes.
Dude, he's never going anywhere again.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, man.
And that's how I saw Bob for the first time in years.
I see him at least probably once a year because usually his team will scrimmage or use the field at junior sports and stuff. And so I used to see him all the time.
I thought you were going to say, yeah, his team usually comes in and kills all of us once a
year. Well, yeah, of course. I mean, his kids are good for travel, obviously. But
Bob had a tryout for Kansas City Royals.
Yeah.
Back in the day, yeah.
He was a pitcher. He's left-handed. He could throw real hard.
Yep. He was a good player. His I don't remember his kids' names. The older one. He has two, right?
Yeah, he has two. The older one's really good.
Yeah, he's really good.
Yeah, he's...
Oh, he's only got two kids?
He's got three, I think.
Oh, okay.
But he has two that are closer in age.
Yeah.
Yeah, because one's a lot older, right?
Well, they got one that's pretty young.
Oh, I thought he started young. with kids.
No, because I think his...
No, he did have one. He has one that's 21.
I was going to say, I thought he had one that's...
Yeah, he had one with another woman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they split up, but there was not a big fight or anything. They're friendly.
The one that's closer to Dobbin's age is really good.
Yeah.
Okay.
But anyway, yeah, they... them two were my coaches. The guy whose son got pro tryouts, and then my dad.
Yeah.
And I got yelled at a lot.
My dad, the little hillbilly.
Yeah, he didn't like... My dad was never like in any way abusive to me. It's just I was the only one he could yell at.
Yeah,
so
right.
Yeah.
So what everyone did, it came back on me. So it was like somehow...
Oh,
I don't know, man. Bri's dad, Ed, he was really bad with Bri, but he was just almost as bad with the rest of the team, is what Bri said. He would just come in and just yell at him, "You missed this, you missed that, you missed..." And, you know, even if they won, didn't matter.
Well, they should have.
You know,
anyone could have won that game.
Yeah, and here he was. He was like this little Polack troll-looking dude from Hamtramck that couldn't play any sports. Like, he's like 5'4". Like,
that's weird because Bri was like 6'3".
He's a big guy.
Yeah, he found out that that's not his dad. His mom had an affair.
Oh.
Yeah.
It looked like Bri looked kind of... Because
if you look at the rest of the family, they're all like little trolls like dad. And Bri's like 6'3", you know, was, you know.
Yeah.
And then I saw a picture of his dad.
He looks like a Native American, too.
Yeah. I saw a picture of his real dad. Yeah.
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 Dude, he likes his... Mom definitely had a fucking affair. Wow. I found out because of that ancestry, dude.
Well, you told me that. I forgot about that.
Found out like 3 months, 4 months before he died. Found out who his sister was, and his sister is a good friend of mine that I've known for like 25 years.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Yep.
But his father was already dead, so he never got to meet him in person. But I saw the pictures.
I remember,
man, it was Bri's dad for sure.
I remember my Uncle Trace came and did one of those 23andMe or whatever, and it was found out. They told my dad, "We're more Indian than we are anything." My dad's like, "I suddenly hate Columbus."
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My dad, the white nationalist native. My dad. Yeah, he's... I don't know why. I'm afraid to take it because you don't know, like, you know, what if I'm not who I thought I was my whole life?
I am not doing it.
I don't want to know who did what.
Now, like it used to be that I refused to do it because I didn't want my DNA out there, but now I'm like, you know, I'm a convicted felon now, so my DNA's on file. I have no choice in the matter.
Yeah.
So it's like, well, now maybe I could do it. But
yeah, what does it matter?
Yeah, before it was like, no, I'm not doing it because my DNA is not getting out there anywhere. Yeah.
I demand freedom, my freedom. Right. Like, no.
Yeah, then like,
so you don't have it anymore.
Yeah, then all of a sudden, when I was in, before I went to jail.
Are you to the point where you can't have a firearm and all that? You gotten to that point?
I got to look and see how this...
I mean, you've never been a gun guy anyway. But.
No, but I got to look and see how this goes because there are, like, levels of felonies, I guess. I don't know, but...
I don't either.
I know that after... I from what I was told, like, after 7 years, I can go and get this knocked to a high misdemeanor if I have no issues. It'll cost me money, but it won't cost me, like, anything like what... a lot of people have to go. I mean, it can be real expensive to get a felony expunged. I wouldn't.
Yeah.
In Michigan, I couldn't get it expunged anyway. All I could do is get it dropped to a high court misdemeanor.
Hmm. Yeah.
Because you never lose like the amount. They never take away. Like if you go to California, if you lived in California, they'll wipe out like after so many years, they'll wipe out your DUIs. Like they don't exist.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm like, what?
We don't feel like fucking. We got so many fucking problems here. Just fucking. We're just going to leave this alone.
Does your Xbox One. You have a One X?
Yes.
Does it make noises like the fan?
It can, yeah.
I've never had my Xbox make a noise like that.
Xbox One, is that the one that's on sale at Best Buy right now for $150?
Probably.
No.
Yeah, I think the digital-only version is $150.
No, that one there...
But his is like a pro
edition. Mine's probably because I need to, like, friggin' spray it with a goddamn...
You cat hair and stuff.
Yeah, I gotta get it like an air compressor and fuck it.
Well, cause I was reading stuff because the new, have you heard of the Xbox Series X?
I may have, yes.
Well, they have a heavier duty fan in it, but only one fan, but it's a central fan.
Mm-hmm.
And they say that it helps so it doesn't overheat, but it keeps the whole thing cool. But they're talking about the jet engine noise and stuff. I'm like, mine has literally never made that noise.
Yeah,
PlayStations have it a lot too. PlayStation 4s.
Now, I had the 1S, which is the step down from that one.
Yeah.
That I sold to your brother, and that one never made a single noise. Now this 1X makes noises sometimes on the graphically demanding games.
Yeah, maybe like that's what it is. I mean, I played Outer Worlds and stuff, but I don't have anything that's super graphically demanding. I didn't play Borderlands 3.
Borderlands 3 isn't... It's not so much that it's graphically demanding. It's poorly optimized. It's like they... Did someone show up at my house?
No way.
Am I going to get swatted?
We're getting swatted, yeah.
It sounds like somebody like pulled up and just got to close the doors.
Yeah.
I mean, unless there's like party, I
have it around here. The odd time I will have people show up here,
yeah,
and just come in, but it hasn't happened in a while.
It's me, Frank, and someone we literally haven't seen in 20 some odd years.
Yeah, Frank. Hey, look, it's
yeah,
it's Chris Jarzembowski.
Like, that one would make more sense.
Yeah, actually, I did. Chris was working the door at that bar.
So I kind of
hung around him for about 5 years ago. I did,
and Craig worked with him at one point. So they were, well, and then wasn't Frank's ex-wife and his woman like good friends, or was that somebody else I'm thinking of? There's somebody that Craig worked with at one point whose wife was good friends with Carrie. That was a while.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No, that's not a different person though.
Yeah,
different person.
But yeah, Xbox Series X is going to have a really good fan. So Phil Spencer told me.
I'll be its number one fan.
Do you watch? You still have Netflix?
Yeah, I do.
Do you watch The Witcher yet?
No, I haven't yet. I want to though.
I've heard. I watched the first episode. You should check it out.
Yeah, I'll check it out.
You should, because it's not based on the games though. It's based on the books.
Yeah, Geralt.
Yeah. So I guess they made some changes from the books, light changes and stuff, but. Other than that, the first episode was good, I thought. I haven't got any further than that.
See, I never read the books. I've only played the games.
Either.
And
yeah.
I played one game. I played Witcher 3, but I put like 200 hours in that fucking game. I loved it.
I guess the major differences are with the two women, Ciri and Yennefer?
Yeah, Yennefer.
They're not in the first two books.
Oh, yeah.
And they're not there till like the third book and... They're like immediately in this show. So
yeah. What about Triss Marigold? She in it?
I don't know. Not yet. Not,
red-haired woman.
No.
Yeah. She's kind of like the. She's cute, but she's like the one most people tend to friend zone because you have a choice between Triss and Yennefer.
Yennefer.
And Yennefer's got the hot fuck me factor.
Yeah.
For a lot of people.
The only ones I know for it's like I said, Ciri and Yennefer so far.
Yeah, that game, man. That game had all kinds of hot ass in it. It was like a Skinamax porn that you got to stab people while playing.
It's a video game.
Yeah,
The Witcher.
Witcher 3.
Yep. And that was the other thing because I guess the guy who wrote the books was gonna take the rights away from. Oh my god, what's the company that made it?
CD Projekt Red.
Yes, thank you. CD Projekt Red, and they had to renegotiate and everything, and for some reason, he wanted all the money. Like they were like, well, we'll pay you this much every year. He's like, no, lump sum. It's like he won the lotto or something. He's like, I want the lump sum. So he took all the money up front, and they re-got the rights, and they're like, now we can make Witcher 4, which you won't see for many years, but we're going to make it.
Yeah, they agreed on a deal. They agreed on an amount.
Yeah.
And the game blew up way bigger than anyone anticipated, and then he was mad and wanted more money.
That's like, basically, how, yeah, but they
yeah, but it's up, like, dude, you agreed. You can't, you know.
Yep. Well, they renegotiated with him.
No take-backsies.
Yeah.
He won in the end. Sorry, that's all that matters.
What do you want? Like, it was like when Kurt Warner won the Super Bowl, he was like league minimum, then they gave him a couple. Like,
yeah.
Well, since it turned out, so here's a couple million for you, bud.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't know we were going to fucking like rival anything that was ever made.
You were bagging groceries 3 months ago.
Yeah, I know.
That game was huge.
Literally. But yeah, that game was a pure riot.
What the? Trust Falls that failed. I'm sorry. I just saw it on the TV.
Oh, dude.
I remember those.
Trust Falls that failed. That failed.
It was bad.
I mean, like.
But yeah, watch The Witcher.
Oh, here we go. Bam.
Make sure I'll probably check it out because.
I know you stopped watching Game of Thrones.
I did, yeah.
But it's sort of like that, but it's not like that. It's not,
I'm trying to go into it with an open mind. I don't want to hold it to a standard of a video game, which no movies never really do anyway. I'm going to almost view it as its own thing.
Yeah.
You know, like it's a series about a video game I really like, but it's based on that world.
It's based on that world, yeah. And that's, I think a lot of people, there's a few people that didn't like it. They're like, oh, it's nothing like the game. It's like, it's not. It's the books. It's not the game. So.
Yeah, and.
If you haven't read the books, then you shouldn't really know too much.
Yeah, because.
It should be a surprise.
Yeah, that guy, too, those books were been around for a pretty long time.
Oh, yeah.
It's not anything new, so. To the people that are actually fans of the books, I'm just a plebeian anyway. Like, you just played Witcher 3, that's it. The one book game.
Oh, yeah.
You're a fucking loser.
Exactly.
Studio gangster.
Yeah.
You're not a real nerd.
Well, they had a bunch of the... They'd made comic books based on the books, too, which didn't do as well. But there was a guy from around here who drew on those books, a guy from Frasier.
Yeah. I
knew.
I feel I was getting kind of excited because my nephew, who's usually here all weekend, he's here right now.
Yeah.
But he hasn't been spending Fridays here. He's been going out with friends. Like, oh, cool, man. Maybe he's being normal and, like, you know, maybe having a little, you know, he's 17. Maybe he's drinking or having a good time. No. I found out. D&D.
I was going to say that. I swear to God. I was going to say that.
Nerd.
And he didn't even tell me. My mom told me. I still haven't confronted him about it.
Oh, my gosh.
She's like, he's playing some... I don't know for a fact it's D&D. She says, but it's a game, but you play it on a tabletop. It's D&D.
It's Risk or something, you know?
No, what's the Catan one?
It has to be D&D.
It's got to be.
Oh, God, what's that called? It's something like Catan.
I know
but
it.
But it's like that, too, and it's supposed to be one of the most complicated games ever. The Catalina Wine Mixer.
It's D&D.
It's D&D.
I know it when I see it. I know the signs.
Yep.
It's like that movie, The Warlock. You know the signs that there's a witch around?
Yeah.
You know there's signs that there's a D&D player around you?
Settlers of Catan is what it's called. It's more intense. It takes forever to play.
Yeah.
Or the Cones of Dunshire. That's a made up game.
See, the reason me and you, Brian, could have never done D&D because we had a lot of friends that were like, everything we did, they were bad cheaters.
Or oh,
like
God.
Shimmels and.
Yeah.
You have to honor it like. My level 8 mage just blasted you. You're dead, and then you're like, the game's over.
Yeah,
I know that it would be like, no, I'm not dead.
Yeah.
Oh, I've just decided that I'm not dead. They would play along with the fucking game, and I'd end up there'd be a fight. Yeah. So I could never do D&D with the guys I grew up with.
As we got a little bit older, late teens, early 20s, there was a group of people we knew, but you know, like Craig's friends and stuff who played it. And they used to claim they were the coolest people to ever play Dungeons & Dragons, like Jay and Rick. Yeah. And I'm like, it's still fucking D&D.
Yeah, I don't care how cool you are.
You're the coolest nerd in the world. Well, I guess actually now that you would, because you're probably
like,
rich.
Really, like, if you think about it, like, it's still played. People still play D&D. Well,
people play it online on a video game.
And I remember, I remember when I was a kid, man, like, you know, there
you
was
had paper and everything.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah. I remember people doing it then. I was pretty young. I was like, you know, it was like that was before I was old enough to really even play it. I remember people playing it.
Yeah,
it's been around a long time.
D&D is basically the precursor to every RPG video game.
Oh yeah,
everything. It's like the Godfather. Precursor. And then that guy was influenced by Tolkien. And
Gary Gygax is
Gary Gygax, right? And
yeah, basically, like,
I wasn't looking that up. I already knew that one.
One day I'm gonna force myself to play one game of it.
You know,
just try.
My buddy Rick, who listens to the show occasionally too, he plays D&D stuff, but he actually plays it's a D&D type game where you create your own Star Wars universe characters and play it that way. And he's like, it's pretty cool and stuff. I'm like, yeah, it's a patience thing, man. I don't know if I could do it.
Yeah, it's cool, you know, if you don't ever want to get laid.
And I would be better off in a Star Wars universe than I would.
Nothing will change in my life, but normal person. I
know, as far as D&D goes, I know next to nothing, but like Star Wars I could probably be okay in. You know, I know enough Star Wars shit that I can create my own character and everything.
Well, the thing is that, like, to even games like that, in World of Warcraft and the video game world, like, I don't know if I want to do a 14-hour campaign with four or five people. You can't, like, this podcast, it's taken me and Brian forever to get a third person.
Yeah.
Right. It's 2 hours.
Yeah.
Talking about whatever we want to talk about. I don't even have a thing that I want people to come over and do.
I don't
want
to do 14 hours with 14, anybody. Yeah.
So can you imagine how hard it would be to do a 14-hour campaign?
Oh, my God, no. God. Oh. I don't want... I go to work and, like, I don't have to see the people that I work with for 14 hours. I really don't. I have my own little world. I see them here and there. I don't even have... I mean, I don't want that. So, I mean, no. I don't want 14 hours doing... Oh, no.
No.
Oh, no.
No, I mean, if you watch some of these people in these groups, these D&D groups, they meet up at 8 o'clock on a Saturday morning, and that's what they do. That's their Saturday. Shut up. My wife keeps...
Oh, my God. That sounds horrible.
And they start like in the morning, though. And they're not done. Done till like, now.
Yeah.
They start at 8 this morning, and they'd be getting done now.
I like you guys, but I don't want to sit here for 14 hours doing this or like anything. Like, no, nothing. There's not.
Is this a challenge?
I wouldn't want to play D&D for 14 hours with supermodels. No. I still wouldn't want to do it.
No.
I don't want to do anything to commit any that kind of time to anything.
See,
I got an argument with my boss because he wants me to work longer hours.
Because it's more than 8 or 9 hours.
Yeah, like, I don't want to fucking do this shit.
Yeah, it's tired. Like, I mean, I do
everything I do is based on it's energy management. That's my life.
Yeah, and
I might get tired after 9 hours. I might die right here on the floor. I don't know.
I do 12 hours, you know, and it's like 12 and a half because, you know, you don't get paid for that lunch or whatever. But I walk in, I start at 3:30. If I walk in at 3:15 and my boss tries to talk to me, I go, it's not 3:30. Yeah. And he's like, well, what do you mean? You know, he gets all butthurt by it. I'm like, dude, leave me alone. I'm going upstairs. I'm putting my lunch away. I'm going to sit down. I'm going to, you know, at 3:30, I will hit the button that says clock in. And then you can tell me anything you want.
Yeah.
Now, is somebody going to challenge us to a 14-hour podcast-a-thon? Because if they did and we got something from it,
well, then
if you're challenging me,
well, yes, because then, I
might do it.
Like, I don't know if I can make it.
Like, when we did that Lord of the Rings thing.
Like, to do something like that once, you know, because, you know, you want to be a winner, you know.
Yeah. A winner, anybody can do a 14-hour podcast.
When me and Rick and my other friend Mike watched all three Lord of the Rings movies back to back to back, the extended uncut editions, and we had feast in between, it was like 14 hours. No joke. And we drank liquor and beer and stuff, too.
Oh, man, but I remember Rachel doing that.
You're talking the four-hour versions of each movie, though.
She's like, I'm going to marathon Lord of the Rings all weekend. I'm like, that sounds horrible.
I did it once here alone, and I bought a Dirty 30.
Of Natty Light?
Of Natty Light.
Yeah.
And I did it alone. And I posted it I was on a forum, which is how I met Phil.
Yeah,
the forum that I was on, and I posted like my progress through the night, and by the end of the night, man, I could barely speak, and it was just a combination of like fatigue and
that
drunk.
Didn't you call the Natty Light comment line, or was that a different time?
No, I did that with Aaron.
Okay, that's right.
But that was that same night. Aaron came over for like 3 hours and then left
because
he wasn't going to sit here and do that shit. He came over for a couple hours and then we called it. And then he
She's
made.
He's like, I'm out, man. I am not watching all this.
We planned this whole thing out. The Gorge of the Rings is what we called it. And we planned out the meal. Cause you know, hobbits have breakfast and then second breakfast and then, you know, mid.
Lunch. And
they eat like 17 times a day.
Yeah, right.
We planned the whole thing out.
So
and
do
we
I.
Had, oh, wow. And then we had, you know, the brown ale and different stuff like they would drink. And Mike actually went to Butcher Boy and got rabbit. Sweet, because we had a braise of conies and we made rabbit stew.
Braise of conies.
Yeah. It was like as legit as we could. The only thing we didn't do was like dress up. We're not fucking LARPers. That's lame.
Yeah, right.
You know, but we ate and drank and watched those movies for 14 and a half hours.
Yeah.
Mike was so wasted. It was his house, luckily. But
we need to do, we need to mimic the Motley Crue party that led to the car crash. Okay. It was like three days of drinking. And
yeah,
we just don't do the DUI part.
Let's not do that, no. We don't want to kill Razzle
again. I want to be Vince Neil.
Yeah. Vince, and then we got to have a friend fall asleep and get washed in the waves.
I called it. I'm Vince Neil.
Yeah.
Hey, man, Vince Neil just lost a bunch of weight. Did you see that?
No.
He lost. Like, yeah, someone let say he lost a bunch of weight recently.
Really?
Yeah.
Such a talented singer.
He didn't take vocal lessons, but he lost weight. You know, that's the thing, though. Did you lose weight, or did you actually get healthy and actually, you know, have stamina and can hold, you know, not lose your breath every 5 seconds?
I don't know, man.
They may have came to him and said, "Hey, if you're gonna be doing this tour, man, you
better shape up.
We're gonna pay you. You know,
you have to get in some shape."
That tour sold 700,000 tickets already.
Because you know, Joe Elliott's gonna come in here and shape.
Yeah,
that's what Joe Elliott does. Like,
try to get it to him that way. You want Brett Michaels with diabetes out, do you? Is that what you want?
Joan Jett's probably in better shape than all of them. But
I mean, if they come here, I may have to go to the show just because, like, I've never seen Def Leppard, but I'm not a fan. But I've never seen them, and I feel that because they were so big in that era and in one of the biggest eras of my life, I should probably go. I've seen Poison.
You're going to see some sagging ass titties.
Well, that's what I'm thinking is, like, you know, I think I just need to go, like, you know, because, you know, I mean, I look way better than most of the people that are going to
be there.
That are there.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, you'll probably be able to outshine.
I mean, I saw, wasn't that long ago. It was a decade ago when I saw Poison. I was out in Utah. We went and saw Poison because it was like $5 at this amphitheater, and we had nothing to do, so we went. And
I saw
women with their daughters there. You know,
I saw a great white outdoors, thankfully. No pyro.
Oh.
Dude. So I was safe. I'm like, okay, I'm gonna be at the back of this hill.
Yeah. I'm in the back. Find where all the fire exits are first.
Yeah, I'm outside. There's no smoke inhalation. I'm good on that front.
Oh, man.
Yeah, when I've talked about it on the show, but that was the perfect storm of absolute shit.
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
Multiple fire. They had soundproofing on the ceilings, and that shit like a spark there can light the whole thing. You know? Right. That shit's just heinous for fire.
Yeah.
And then they had one entrance, and then one guy, his wife or girlfriend died because the bouncer wouldn't let him go out the band. It's like, dude, when all bets are off, when shit, let people out, dude.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. It was horrible. It was like the perfect storm of bullshit, you know, fire code thing. Too many people in the venue.
Mm-hmm.
One exit. I mean, I could just go on and on. Sprinkler system fucking failed.
Oh,
everything just that could have went wrong did.
The club was a walking violation of everything bad. Yeah.
Yeah, it's just... And you watch one of the most haunting videos. Like, I actually, you know, I don't watch a whole lot that bothers me to the point where I can't sleep like a little kid. But that one, I watched the raw video of it. And they're all like wedged in that door like a human clay because that fire's just coming behind them.
Ugh.
And they can't move and they know it's coming and they're all screaming. I was like, dude, I can't. Like, it fucked my sleep up.
I'm not watching. Yeah,
it's one of the things, all joking aside, I wish I'd never saw that was bad.
And I'm
horrific.
I'm glad I've never seen it, and I never will watch it.
Yeah, it's bad.
It's bad.
Because when you hear like hundreds of people screaming at once, it's pretty rough. All right, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. So when you saw that poison show in Utah, was Phil there?
He might have been.
Phil,
were you there?
Did you go see Poison at the $5 amphitheater show?
Yeah, like, I don't know. There was this summer that we saw like a bunch of shows. Like Rachel kept finding them. She's like, "Hey, there's this Incubus show. If we buy tickets today, it's $10." I'm like, "Well, get them." You can't see shows for that cheap anymore.
$10
like,
for Incubus.
You know, I'm like, you can't see shows. That's where I blew out my calf muscle.
Yeah, when you did.
I can do this backflip.
I can still do backflip. I did it, and I landed it.
Phil says negative. He was not there.
Why?
Why? All right. Well, we're gonna take the halfway point because I want to make a coffee and wake up a little bit.
That sounds good.
Yeah. And we're gonna play River Bottom Nightmare Band. We're gonna play Brian's wife's cousin's band,
which was cool.
I like the band. Final Days Fading. The song's called Shallow Grave, and we're gonna play it and make a coffee, and we'll be right back with the Discord on for Phil.
Vaginas, I mean, whatever.
You can't say that on stream, dude. If you
you actually have like 100 people in here and you can't say,
listen. Yeah, listen. First of all, my stream is 18 and older. So, hey, how y'all? No, it does matter because it's mature content only. So if I say fucking pussy, or I'm gonna fucking spread some fucking pussy lips, no, don't say that.
I got two mics.
Yeah, man, you're racist as fuck. You know what? You need Jesus in your life. You need Jesus, boy! Jesus! I'm gonna fuck him up for saying that. Yup! No. Hey, Morgara.
Shut up, take the garbage out. Fuck off.
Morgan! Shut the fuck up! Hey, listen. On a real note, please, tell the people how amazing...
Look, I don't care about your real note. Just take the garbage out.
That's what I'm talking about. Straight up ass shot, Forrest Gump style, right in the fucking dick.
Yeah.
Morgan, I fucking love you. I love playing this game with you. I wish I could play with you on a daily basis, 24/7. Where'd you go?
I'm right here. I didn't go nowhere.
My guy didn't show up. Hey, you see that guy right there with the big?
Hey.
I had four kills.
You need to learn how to manage your surroundings.
Murder, man, and Jeffrey Epstein. So you got the leader of the. What is going on here? No,
let's take some down.
It's on. I just to your fucking dome, try hard my nuts.
So bad.
I'm fucking crying. My name's Ace. Oh, Ace. They're so try hard. They're so sweaty. I'm crying. Eat my dick. How do you think they like that?
And we're back.
Hi.
I had to get a coffee and recharge at 11 o'clock at night. We have the Discord on, which means we got Phil back. Hello, Phil. How you doing?
Hola, senior. How are you doing?
And we have the honorary Canadian, so we have some diversity. Hoge. What's up, Hoge?
Hey, we don't discriminate, man.
So,
all nationalities.
All nationalities. So you went on a cruise recently.
I did.
Did you have fun on the cruise?
It was a solid time. I got no complaints about it.
Did you get some more Golden Corral?
I did not have Golden Corral, but I mean the buffet there was pretty much on par with Golden Corral.
So did you get the shits?
Yeah, I did.
Yep. Totally Golden Corralled it.
Were you on the ships that crashed into each other?
Nope. Oh, nope. Right.
We were hoping for some gore.
Watch, though.
Did you play shuffleboard?
I thought I was going to when we were taking the shuttle from the parking lot to get to the boat. I was probably the youngest person on that shuttle by 30 years, and ironically, I actually made a Facebook post saying that I was going to get really good at shuffleboard.
Yeah.
That's lame. Shuffleboard's really cool, though. I'm just saying. I've never played it, but...
Did you do the Charleston with them, or whatever the old people do?
I don't know what the fuck that is.
That's an old. How many
kits that were tucked into bikini bottoms did you see?
I tried to stay away from the old ladies in their bikinis.
Oh, sounds like you missed out on a good time, but hey, that's just me.
Well, I mean, my old lady was with me, so I didn't, you know, want to get caught
some Googling old, breezy, old ladies. As they're called. Mm-hmm.
So I heard a vicious rumor you found an American girl. Is that true?
I cannot confirm or deny.
See, that means it's true.
That 100% means it's true.
Yo, I gotta say, actually being with them, like being around her is pretty funny on, like, just the differences. I didn't know that you guys can get hamburgers that aren't fucking, like, fully cooked. You can get, like, a rare hamburger.
Good. Yeah.
That's odd to me.
Yeah, you can't get that in Canada?
What is it?
No.
Banned?
No, there's... I don't know if we have regulations on it. I've just never heard of someone asking, how
is
do you want your hamburger
taking a leak
done?
In the background?
Phil, are you pissing?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, because, like, I always order my burger.
No, I'm making the coffee.
I order it medium, cooked medium.
Yeah.
Not rare, yeah, because that's just, you know, that's messed up.
That's but, fucked to me.
Yeah.
Well, if you go to a shitty enough McDonald's, you're getting it rare anyway, and then you're going to get botulism and whatever See, else.
I was always a well-done person, and that's the way we were brought up, was well-done.
Yeah.
Because...
That's why I hated steak.
Yeah. It was always so dry. And then when I got married, my wife's family, they're all Sicilian and stuff, and they're like, how do you want your steak? And I'm like, well, they're like, we don't do well here.
Yeah, right.
Everything was like medium.
Yep.
We got to wait an hour so this fuck's steak is done.
My high school girlfriend, I remember going to Melissa's house and her dad making these beautiful looking like inch thick steaks. And I cut into it. I go, oh, this thing's raw. And he goes, no, that's rare. And I'm like, it's raw. It's pink. It's bloody. And he goes, well, look, I'll throw it on the grill for you, but that's rare.
I
don't know. My mom throws steak in Italian dressing for 3 days and then throws on a grill. I don't know. That's why I hate steak, you know. And he's like, well, just, you know, if you want to try it. And as soon as I took a bite, I was done. Never again am I going backwards.
And
you know?
No offense to mom and dad, but they couldn't afford the good steaks.
No.
So, like, if you ever go to, like, the real...
you guys are poor.
And get, like, a Delmonico or something. Yeah, I forgot you guys were the wealthy ones.
Yeah. My dad was wealthy by maybe a dollar more an hour.
Yeah, maybe. but it was, yeah, when I... The first
he, wasn't,
I had, like,
he wasn't, like, perpetually laid off from jobs.
No.
You know? Yeah.
I had a Delmonico at one of her family functions. This is like a year after we got married. And it was the most fantastic steak I ever had in my entire life. It was so good. And then I had a filet for the first time. I'm like, what the fuck is this?
Mm-hmm.
This godsend here. This is like, it's like I'm eating the flesh of Jesus. or something.
Yeah. Like, I'm like, yeah. Like, my favorite though, to me, this is my favorite is a ribeye, because I like the fat in between and stuff. Once I found a really good ribeye, not like cheap cuts.
No, it's gotta be good cuts.
So Hoge, did you zip line or do any of that dumb shit that cruise people do?
I was pretty fucking hungover when we went to Haiti, and that's where we were gonna go zip lining.
Fuck that.
We went.
Yeah.
You would have zip line right into a kidnapping.
No, they don't let you leave the resort there. It's like it's actually pretty cool there. But we went snorkeling, and my fucking luck, there's a hole in the goddamn thing. So I'm sucking in dirty ocean water in Haiti the whole time.
Yeah.
Almost stepped on a sea urchin.
Sounds like Fast and the Furious is going on outside your house.
Yeah.
Mike.
Yeah. Did you hear it?
Yeah. It's
me.
My neighbors are, I don't know.
Somebody's
no, this mic, not you, Hoge.
Yeah, they're gay tarded.
Yeah. Somebody's ripping through the neighborhood with their little Fast and Furious cars.
Phil, where was that postcard like picture of you taken? That beautiful lake?
What Echo Reservoir up the canyon.
Oh yeah, like up you talking about like up near like other side of Ogden, right?
Yeah, south of Ogden, north of Park City.
Yeah, north okay, yep.
Looked pretty serene and gorgeous, I must say.
It was a fucking blast.
It looked Photoshopped to me.
That's fine. You're a retard.
Hey, so, you don't make fun of me because Frank's not here, right?
No.
Basically,
no.
When I go,
somebody's
got
to get you going.
I'm going to rock.
Yeah.
Can someone call Frank? put us on speakerphone so I can say fuck you, Frank, and then just hang up?
He wouldn't answer right now.
He won't answer.
He's got his other friends.
You should give me Morgan's number. I'll call Morgan.
His real friends. Well, if Morgan was not at work, he would be on here saying Steve Perry over and over again for some reason. I don't know what that was about.
Basketball. Man.
I know, but like why he kept doing it.
We were talking about Journey at the time.
Yeah, we were talking about Journey, but yeah.
But he didn't. What I mean is, I know why, but why he kept not doing anything else but saying
that. Yeah, he was just doing that.
Yeah,
he just kept doing it. Yes.
I should rephrase that.
Do you remember when we got into prank the chick that I was dating?
No. I do not.
Admit.
No, I just vaguely remember that, Oj.
Oh, I remember that.
She burst into tears because he's got that heavy, like, southern accent. And she wouldn't leave me alone. And we were trying to play Call of Duty or something. And he's like, tell her to fuck off. I'm like, man, she's going to show up outside my house. Like, give me your number. So I gave Morgan my girlfriend's number and he called her. Started like fucking with her, and then she called me all mad saying that I have this worst accent, blah 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 blah. Like, wait, you just got a call from like a hillbilly? And she goes, yeah. I'm like, I'm on my way to your house right now. And she goes, what? I'm like, do you not read the fucking news? Goes, no, what are you talking about? I'm like, that's a serial rapist. He's outside your house. It's what he does, and then he breaks in. And she just fucking lost it.
You know, it's not that far off. If he were around, there would be some level of danger for her.
There would be some danger.
Especially if you gave him the okay, you know?
Morgan was in Xbox party chat.
Through the hole in his sweatpants.
I could see Morgan skinning some teenagers and stuff.
Oh, Jesus.
You know,
but he heard the whole conversation, and then he called her back, and it was saying, like, I'm outside your house. Like,
that's right.
It was bad, man. Like, she was fucking pissed. But I was, like, 19 years old, and I thought that was funny.
That is funny. What?
I'm 40, and I think that's funny.
I'm 46, and I'm cracking up. I totally love it.
Yeah.
I have like, an infatuation with serial killers, too, so that's, like, even better.
Yeah.
Speaking of, Apple Music got rid of fucking the Dahmer record. On Friday, those fucks.
Well, they got rid of it Friday? Macabre,
yep.
Dahmer. Wow.
Yep, that's gone Friday.
They took it off
All
Apple
Macabre
Music.
All Macabre is gone.
No way, really?
Probably because we talked about it.
Yeah, probably,
that's what
man.
It is, yeah.
What the fuck?
We're such heavy influence on people.
That album's so incredible.
We had 200 views on YouTube.
That album's just wicked.
Oh, I guess I was downloaded illegally.
Yeah, that album is wicked.
So it's not on Apple, but you could still get it somewhere else.
I could get it. I can get anything.
Jeffrey was a little.
I mean, I know a guy that's yelling at me.
He's a player with Roadkill.
Jeffrey joined the army.
Jeffrey
was a player with Roadkill. He was a hitchhiker thumbing for a ride.
Yeah.
That song is fucking just.
Dude,
that's the best song on the record.
My house. He didn't realize if he tried to leave, he had to die.
Yeah. Yeah, Dennis the Menace, dude, their drummer is fucking so fast.
Oh, yeah.
He was so fast. They were considered, I read a thing, they were considered the world's fastest band until Dragon Force came along.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, I remember when Bri first played him, he was like, check this out.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh my God. He's like, this is fucking awesome. I'm like, yeah. He goes, they're coming to play here soon. I'm like, we're going.
Yeah.
Were they wicked live?
I've seen him four times live.
Yeah.
Who is it?
Four times here live, and I saw him once, like in like some fucking dude, some podunk fucking Indiana fucking bar, dude.
The G.G. Allen thing. We were in an abandoned gas station seeing Macabre. The band's called Macabre, Hoge. Macabre. It's spelled Macabre.
Yeah. Macabre.
They're fucking wicked.
They're fucking awesome. But I had Bri burn me that CD. Like, dude, I gotta have this song. So you guys play it for me. And, So, anything else cool happen on the cruise, Hoge, at all? Anyone fall overboard?
Someone, like the last day, no one fell over. But on the last day, we woke up in the morning. It was like 5 o'clock, and I had a water bottle on the thing, like on the counter in the room, and it fell over and all the fucking coat hangers are all smashing into each other, and I had a belt hanging from something, like from a hook, and it was slamming into the wall. And she woke up. What's going on? I'm like, I don't know. We're probably fucking sinking, and tried to go back to sleep. And then we just heard an announcement saying there's an emergency on like deck 8.
Like some, right, some fat person like ran to the wrong side of the
Oh, this was like 5 o'clock in the morning. So we got up.
Were you guys hit waves or around. Something?
Yeah, there's waves and we didn't know what the fuck was going on. So we started walking around the elevators. You could hear the cables slamming in there. I'm like, this is kind of fucked. I'm like, well, let's go up the elevator to the top deck and see what's going on. I'm not getting in that. I'm like, well, all right, see ya. I'm going up. So he went up and there's like fucking drunk people all partying upstairs. They don't realize anything's going on.
That's how I would be coping.
The captain came on at like 11 o'clock in the morning and he's just like, just so you guys know, the boat is going full speed. We need to get close to Miami. There's a medical emergency, blah, 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 blah. Turns out there's two people so fucked up that they had to get like a boat to come out and pick them up. And we ended up docking like 16 hours early.
Someone got so hungover, like so drunk, they almost killed themselves.
No, man, it's probably some old person is fucking dying.
Yeah.
Like, it's full of old people.
They don't have, like, a helipad on there or something?
Yeah, but apparently Miami, they won't come and pick them up or something. That's what someone was saying. No. I ain't
give a shit. They're sick of picking up the old people from Miami.
Like, they were hauling ass trying to get to, trying to get there early.
I was like, no, I'm going to die, but panic.
So you had to come back into port early, so did you get a refund on part of your trip?
No, and they wouldn't let us off the boat either.
What?
So they shut down the casino and stopped all their duty-free sales, and then people just partied in the port of Miami.
I'd be asking for some money back. You cut my trip short.
Yeah. Oh, man, it was a good time.
I'm scaling the boat. I'm getting off.
When we were in Jamaica, we went rafting down some river. We climbed some waterfalls. I know Phil loves waterfalls. That's why.
Fucking waterfalls, bud.
And then we went rafting. We go into a sketchy fucking neighborhood. It's like these little shanties, and you get on these little, like, ghetto. They were like tires with plywood tie wrapped to them underneath, and we go down a river. And I'm like, this is probably the dumbest thing I've ever done in my life. Like, this is like the ghettoest neighborhood I've ever seen in my life.
You probably get good drugs there, though.
There was Rasta standing on the side of the fucking river smoking weed, and like.
Dude,
there's always old people with some like nerdy people, and I got tattoos on my chest, and they're like pointing to me, and they're like smoking weed. You, I'm like, no, I'm good, dudes. I'm good. I don't want no. This is
hey, fellas, you know where I could deposit all this cash I got on me?
Yeah, especially you're in a foreign country and you're in some really seedy area. You're getting like there's drugs that aren't.
No one looks like you where I'm from.
Drugs that don't even exist. You know,
I just thought it was really fucked, man. Just being in the water in a river and like just felt vulnerable. Like there's like if anything were to happen.
Oh, they ain't gonna come in the water.
I couldn't do anything.
You're fine. Just don't get out of the water. You'll be okay. That's what I heard. I'm not, you know.
Oh,
it's an old rumor.
That's a life pro tip.
It's old rumor. Just like
it's like when you play dead in front of a bear. He's not going to attack you.
Stay in the water.
Stay in the water.
They're not going to get in. Yeah, you're perfectly safe. I don't know. That's the thing with me. I'm so paranoid about third world countries. If I go on a cruise, I'm just staying on the ship.
Yeah.
We're going into port. We're like, all right, yeah, I'm staying here.
So, see you later.
There's no way. Oh, yeah. I've heard that joke before, Hoge. Many times I've heard it.
Hoge, are you still there? Did you get died?
No.
He put something that wasn't in our chat, though. Only I could see it as a direct message.
Yeah.
It's an old joke. An oldie, but
old
a goodie.
Joke or old
is
fact.
It insensitive in a racial way?
Yes.
Figured that because you didn't share it yet.
Those Canadians.
Yeah. Well, it's one area. It's not. It's pretty racist.
Yeah.
But it's not as bad as I thought.
All right, well,
you know, but I've heard.
You can tell us afterwards if you want.
Yeah, we don't have to say.
A buddy of mine owns a bar, and I used to work there, and he used to refer to people that lived in the neighborhood because it was in a bad neighborhood, several miles from here. And instead of saying other words, he called them Canadians.
Oh, that was the code for a while. Yeah, we all remember that, the code. But then they caught on to it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Like, how come I'm around these white people? They call me Canadian.
Oh,
I know what this is.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, he was saying something about all these fucking Canadians in here, and they're like, I know what that means.
Then they hand you a jar of mayo, tell you to shut up.
I mean, fuck Canadians, though, for real.
Yeah. You can say that because you're one. You're an Uncle Tom then.
No, I'm an Albertan.
Yeah,
Albertan.
Yeah.
You might as well be French.
No. Complete opposite of them.
Is it okay?
You hit your
head. Who's getting yelled at?
Well, tell me, what were you doing?
If you're like Quebec, right? That's like French land.
Someone got yelled at. Yeah.
It's like frog country. Who's getting yelled at?
I think it was
Phil. Has to go to bed.
What'd you do, Phil?
Phil had to go to bed. Phil has a
bedtime. Oh, Phil has to go to bed.
It's bedtime, Phil.
Hey, it's 2 hours earlier there, dude.
He's got a hockey game in the morning.
Oh, he's got a hockey game?
I don't know.
I need 100% sleep. I got to be at my best for my pickup hockey game.
So, yeah.
He's got to keep
yell. That. So I can yell at the ref.
He's got to keep that plus 23 up there, man.
He needs to find a new hobby.
Yeah, Hoge, we're thinking about going on a cruise.
Yeah.
Couple of us here, but it's going to be the Monsters of Rock 80s cruise.
Yo,
that one looks wicked.
Yeah, we're going. Well, I'll let you know when it is. You can meet us at the port.
Well, like basically
February, not this February, but the next.
Basically, starting the next haircut I get, I'm stopping getting the haircut in the back.
Are you going to do the mullet?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
I figure that's what 14 months or so. Of straight up growing. Yeah, I mean, if I can, I get some of that special hair, that special shampoo that helps it grow even faster. Yeah, I'll have me a good, like, eight inch mullet going off the back there by that time.
It'll be rocking like Doc.
Awesome. Yeah. That's what I'm thinking.
The thing that makes that cruise the best is the fact that there's a band actually called Jesse's Girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Instead of Rick Springfield.
Oh, I think this is the hair metal one, though. I don't think it's the 80s pop one.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Which the 80s pop one might, in a way, be funner, but I don't know.
Maybe in some ways, because, like, yeah, it's like got, like, I don't know, it's got, like, all different kinds of music, you know.
Samantha Fox.
It's got Grandmaster
Flashman.
That's all you need.
I don't know. I think Samantha Fox is still alive.
If she's still alive, then there's a chance she'll be on that cruise.
Who is it?
Okay,
Samantha
now,
Fox.
Right, well, now we got to make a decision here.
She is not on that list.
Do I want to see, 60-year-old Samantha Fox?
Yeah. Touch me. Touch me. I'm on your body. I'd start touching myself.
I would do it just, out of spite. You know, I'd just, like, jam my hand down my pants right in front of the stage. Yeah.
I'd be like, Samantha Fox. I want
What's the name of the one
like,
you guys are looking
I'd
at?
Be like, I've been doing this since I was 15 to you, baby.
You fellas fancy a double team? Yeah, sure.
Yep.
Yeah, we'll do it.
Yep.
I don't care how old you are. You're Samantha Fox. I'm doing it.
Hey. Hey, Mike, we're cousins. You might see my dick. Sorry.
Yeah. We could put up a blocker.
Yeah, yeah.
You get the mouth, and I get the, we'll switch.
We'll drop a blanket in between.
They even got VJs on that one.
Ooh.
Nina Blackwood, Mark Goodman, and Alan Hunter.
Oh, the originals.
Oh, yeah, the originals.
The three originals. Well, they can't have J.J. Jackson because he died.
He's dead. You want to hear some of the lineup for that one?
Mm-hmm.
The B-52s.
Yep.
Brett Michaels.
Well, you get Poison.
Right? Just Brett Michaels.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you'll get Poison songs.
This one will.
All his great solo albums.
This one will take your breath away. It's Berlin.
Berlin. All right.
Loverboy.
You hearing this, Hoge?
Oh,
we got to do this.
Oh, yeah, I'm looking at it. I was sold on Grandmaster Flash.
Asia, Lita Ford.
Grandmaster Flash?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Oh, fuck off.
Lita Ford's
Katrina. Oh, yes, I did see Katrina formerly from Katrina and the Waves.
The Jets. Like,
all right, the name is your band. Why didn't you just get New Waves? Why do you have to be just Katrina now? Yeah.
One guy from Spandau Ballet and one guy from the outfield.
All right, guys, we got to switch our mission here.
Yeah.
What's the name of the other crews?
Tony, what's his name from Spandau Ballet?
Tony Hadley.
Yeah, Hadley, yeah.
And Tony Lewis from the outfield.
Yeah, well, that's because the other guy's dead.
Yeah.
It's just the bass player from the outfield. The guitar player died.
Asia's good, though.
Asia minus... No. Jeffrey Downs, he died too.
I say Lita Ford already.
Yeah,
yeah.
Big Country. Yeah,
this one sounded this one's sounding better than the '80s hair one.
But he's right. Grandmaster Flash is sounded pretty good.
Grandmaster Flash,
but no Furious Five, just Grandmaster Flash.
The other ones are probably all dead
from drugs.
Yeah. Well, drugs are urban
living
life.
In the ghetto. Yeah. I mean, it wasn't like they
It was the drugs.
I don't know
that
if the
they
Furious
forced
Five made
people pissing on the streets that just don't care.
I don't know if a lot of the Furious Five made a lot of money.
Yeah.
And is it? It's Patty Smythe from Scandal, right?
It's Patty Smythe from Scandal. Or
it's Patty Smythe and Scandal.
Yeah, yeah. It was always that way. It was always Scandal featuring Patty Smythe.
Did they do The Warrior?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Yep. She was supposed to be the singer. She was supposed to take over when David Lee Roth left.
That was one of the rumors.
That was what.
Yeah.
That, no, they wanted her. They weren't even going to audition her. They wanted her, and she said she wanted to stay with Scandal.
Oh, that was a good idea.
Yeah,
because Scandal had that long
run of
two
one
more
song.
Years.
Yeah,
I think this
well,
is...
they were coming off of that great song Warrior, and then they had that
bang,
next
bang.
Album that.
Literally, I know other songs.
We got to do this one, Hoge. We got to change it. So the Radio Underground. Cruise is going to be this one. We're doing this one.
80s pop. Now, that's a 2020. Pop. Who knows what's going to be on 2021 when you guys
go.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Because that's this February. We're going on the
following.
But it'll probably be the similar calendar.
See, yeah.
You know, I can tell you who we're not going to get.
Right? Who?
That would be fucking awesome. Would have been Falco.
Well, yeah. Except for...
Falco's dead.
Yeah, died. Dead thing. I know.
Yeah,
it would have fucking hit a tree.
What about Gary Glitter?
Dude, they should have what's his name? What's it Rockwell?
I always feel like
he's still alive.
Watching.
Hell yeah, he is.
Yeah.
That's Barry Gordy's son.
The guy that did the verse track for him's gone.
Yeah.
he left Neverland.
Basically, yeah, dude. Like basically that would be like well, we'll see what you know. Yeah, it's like we're not going on
what,
this
what,
one,
how,
Coach, because no. like I'm on probation.
Yeah,
because I'm a bad kid.
now Hoge, how far out do you got to get tickets for a cruise typically?
Fuck, man, we bought ours like a month before we went.
Okay,
but
I think on these like these specialized ones with the groups,
probably
and stuff,
a year.
I would imagine there was still some there were still some tickets left for this one this year, the Monsters of Rock one. But it was not for anything that we could afford.
The pop cruise is nothing left.
Yeah.
Yeah, there was like nothing we
there's
could afford.
A waiting
I mean,
list.
Like $7,500.
Ooh!
Like $7,500, $8,500 room.
Like VIP shit only.
Yeah, like gold VIP. Yeah, I was like,
Well.
Can you imagine
we've narrowed it to two, and we're going to narrow it to price after that.
Yeah, I mean.
And availability.
To me, I look at it this way. Like, you know, if I got a year to save for it, I mean, I make good money. I'm going to enjoy what I want, you know, because you can do payments. You can set up. You give them a certain chunk down, and then you give them so much.
Pretty soon, this cruise will be mine.
Yeah.
I got a cruise and a layaway.
I'm looking at the 70.
I got to go pay on my layaway.
The 70,000 tons of metal.
Yeah,
that's that real heavy.
That's
one, right?
No, that one would be like the music I like the most.
Yeah.
But there'd be like no women on that.
Yeah, I mean, if you want a sausage fest, then
no. But if you think about like the women, like you'd go to the top deck where the pools are, and you're not going to see anybody because they're all goss fucking hiding like vampires down in the fucking lower decks, man.
The women that you would see at that on that cruise are going to be with dudes.
Do they have like gothic cruises where the real party's at like the boiler room, the bowels of the ship?
No, I'm not going to lie. One day before I die, I want to go to the Gathering of Juggalos.
Gathering of the Juggalos? No.
Dude.
I don't like ICP at all.
I already live where they're from, man. I don't need to.
The pictures of it look great.
They're gigantic in a lot of places.
They're gigantic. When I walked, when I first moved, I was there like 2 weeks, and I saw these dudes walking across the street in Salt Lake City, full makeup, dressed like juggalos. I'm like, who are those guys, juggalos? And they're like, oh, yeah, man, they're huge out here. Okay.
They had a big following in Cleveland, too.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that's where they have it, and it's in Ohio, isn't it?
I knew guys that like took their vacation time that I worked with, took their vacation time. I'm like, we're going to the gathering of the juggalos. I'm like,
oh, what really? The fuck?
They're a federally recognized gang.
Yeah, I know,
dude.
It's unbelievable.
It's really ridiculous because that
they don't hurt anybody.
No, please.
They're harmless. They're just they have a wrestling events and fights and entertainment, and they like mosh in the mud and do whatever the fuck juggalos do.
Is when that first happened, when they first were federally noticed like that, you know how hard it is to get off the FBI list after that?
And you're never getting off.
No.
I'm on one.
Do you guys?
I'm on one for when I was broadcasting on FM.
Yeah.
I'll be on it my whole life now.
You guys want
to? When that dude lived with me and he was doing the child porn thing,
that list you're never going to.
They found it on his computer, but they took my computer. They took my computer, which had nothing on it, and they said, "Yeah, you know, we got to scan it and everything, and you'll get it back." I was already living here. It was like a year and a half ago. They sent me something saying if I wanted my computer back, I could have it. That was 7.5 years ago.
Didn't you come home from work and then they had their street barricaded off and all that shit?
I was like getting ready to go look at new cars. I'd just gotten off work that morning. I was cleaning my car out because I was thinking about trading it in. And this, all of a sudden, my house was surrounded by FBI.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah. They asked me if I had a gigatribe or if I knew what a gigatribe was, and and apparently the look on my face said it all. I did not know what a gigatribe
was.
What
is that?
It's something that basically pedophile circles were using at the time to share, but not really get caught.
So, okay.
Well, I'm glad I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
Gigatribe?
Yeah.
No, I thought the acronym was, or the not the, the. I heard another one. They always call it cheese pizza.
Oh,
no. CP.
Oh, I never heard that either.
No, I never did.
Yeah, that's the, I've heard that one before, but I never heard Giga Drive.
I still remember the lead guy in charge was way cool. He was like a super dude, he was like super cool, period, a cool person, but his hair was slicked. He looked cool, a cool motherfucking special agent and shit.
Like Don
and his
Johnson?
His name was Jeffrey Ross.
Oh, oh wow.
Jeffrey Ross.
Agent Jeffrey Ross, and well, he was a bad motherfucker.
So how long, is he still in prison, the guy you live with?
No. He did his time. He's he lives in Michigan. Yeah, he lives in Michigan. He's doing
He can't come
right.
over.
Yeah, he's doing all right. He lives
not
in Jackson.
Here, ever.
He lives in Jackson, you know. I mean, I got more of the story after. I got more of the story afterward, and really, what something happened when he was here for his dad's funeral, and that's really what happened back in Utah. Really, wasn't as bad, and they even let me know. They're like, "Look, we want you to know that this isn't," because I was ready to stab him when they were.
Yeah, you have a predator in your fucking house. Yeah,
but. They were like, look, you know, what was going on wasn't as bad as you think. And then they were like, he actually helped. There was 35 arrests made because of him. Of serious pedophiles who actually committed acts physically on children.
Good.
Well, so, you know, but. Regardless,
this has been the most upbeat show ever.
He's been in advanced psychotherapy for years. So
crazy though.
We're not friends, but I have communicated with him hey, how you doing? But we don't talk.
Yeah, don't open up any files he sends you.
Fuck.
He might be able to use a computer now, but he couldn't. he still couldn't a few years ago.
Yeah, that's fucked up.
Well, that was part of like the parole, you know, after he did his time. I mean, there was a certain amount of years he couldn't. And if he did, like for jobs or anything like that, because like he got a good job and like bought a house and everything, you know, he just lives on the other side of the state. So.
That was a pretty intense story though. I remember when I heard it.
Yeah,
but you know, Hoge, you were talking about the your trip kind of ended on a sour note there with the hurrying back to Miami.
Oh, it didn't faze me, but yeah.
So I have it because I'll never have him here. I got to tell this story because I haven't seen him in years. Remember Kent?
Yeah.
So Kent, he went to the Grand Canyon with his out of shape girlfriend. She wasn't massively overweight or anything, but just a total like prissy girl. Like, hadn't used her office job, hadn't used her muscles for anything.
Right.
They went to the Grand Canyon, and he paid good money, like $1,100. To have a guide take them down the Grand Canyon, down the switchbacks.
Oh, dude, that is not cheap.
But he paid the $1,100 to get a helicopter ride back up because going up that is intense.
Right.
It's 11 hours.
Yeah.
Anyway, he was down, and they did their 2 days down in the, you know, there in the waterfalls and the, you know, making out and all that, having a great time. When the helicopter came to pick up the people that had paid the good money to get the helicopter, they said, "You're not on the list." He goes, "What do you mean?" It's like, "I paid, you know, showed the receipt. I paid $1,100 to get a because there's no way she can make it up there." And they're like, "Sorry, you're not on the list." They fucked it up. So he had to take this total, like, homebody girl up the Grand Canyon, 11-hour, and she was, like, getting dizzy and shit. And they finally made it.
Did they have a donkey?
Well, they had it. Well, they wouldn't even have had a guide to tell them how to get up there, but a group of like people that just go there all the time happened to be walking by. Well, we'll take you up. We'll go at your pace.
You can pay for a guide to go down, but not up.
Well, he didn't pay for a guide to take him up because he paid for a helicopter.
He paid for a helicopter.
So they were in theory going to just leave him down there, you know? Like, and so he and his girlfriend. Did the 11-hour walk up there? He goes. It was a new kind of tired. Like when I got it done.
Oh yeah.
He goes. We made it to the top, and then we had to walk an extra, I don't know how many miles to their car and everything. They called the company obviously to complain and like.
Oh.
And Kent's like, I had. And he said I had to fucking walk 11 hours out, and I paid the. They're like, sir, we're sorry, we screwed up this and that. Yeah. The only thing they offered him was half off the next time he comes. He's like, I'm never coming back here, ever.
Here's your money back, and here's half off the next time.
No, they didn't even give him his money back. They only offered him half off should he come back. He didn't get a dime back, nothing.
Oh, hell no.
And all they did is offered him half off if he comes back.
Dude, I would have paid, like, I would have paid 11 grand for a lawyer just to torment them.
Yeah.
And for the principal.
I would have paid a fucking cartel to hack them up.
Oh, yeah.
I would have, like, fuck.
There's no cartels near Arizona.
No.
Yeah, that's why I brought up the cartels. Right. They're like, hey, guys, I got a favor for you. I don't need any cocaine, but I need this travel company here. You're going to go in? like,
maybe some cocaine to sell.
Here, I have some cocaine for you.
But you have to hack somebody up with a machete for me.
Yeah, all right.
So I'm too much of a pussy to do it.
The first one is the one who told me that was on the helicopter and told me that I wasn't on the list.
You got to kill the pilot.
That's number one.
Pilots first.
And whoever runs that fucking place.
Yeah. That nightmare trip was pretty... pretty bad.
Dude.
Do you want me to flip your mood from being depressed to making you laugh your ass off?
Yeah, that was
so.
We got it all.
We want to do it.
I'm looking at the Gathering of the Juggalos 2020 thing here. I think I'm gonna go. It's got Bone Thugs and Harmony, Ghetto Boys, KRS-One, Gwar,
Bushwick's
Mac
dead,
Sabbath.
Yeah, how are they doing Ghetto Boys? Bushwick's
Black
dead.
Sabbath.
Mac Sabbath is
Mac
going.
Sabbath.
Not black. Mac Sabbath. They're the ones that dress up in the McDonald's characters.
Yeah.
Play.
They're on that. They're on that.
I about to say, I see Tony Iommi jamming at fucking
they're on
Butcher Babies.
Yeah.
The chicks from that band are fucking gorgeous. They got Randy from the Trailer Park Boys, Gilbert Godfrey, Morris Day and the Time.
Dude.
But wow. Okay, so no, here's the kicker. So I went through everything. I'm sending you a link, and you have to look at this because I can't describe this.
Okay. Senate. Let's see here.
You got to go to their webpage and just look at them.
Where is the gathering at?
Odd Squad Family.
It's in Indiana.
That's too far.
What? Meet the squad. Okay. Oh my God, he's got nubs.
Nubbin.
He got nub arms.
Albino.
Then an albino African American.
Diversity, man.
Yeah, so you got him. You got a regular black guy with a NASA fucking coat.
OSF.
OSF.
OSF, baby. OSF.
Nubs. The guy's name is Nubs. That's his actual name.
Of course it is.
Snowman. That's got to be the albino black guy. And A Factor.
All right.
What the fuck?
Nubs.
Snowman.
Snowman. A Factor. Frosty.
Frosty. Nubs. Jesus Christ. This is astounding.
Their content is an inspiring blend of positive vibes and classic hip-hop influences intertwined with a fresh, modern delivery.
Like how
I'm
the
watching
two are,
their music video. It's great.
There's two sitting in a... The two normal-sized guys are sitting in a... Nubs is also a dwarf, apparently, because he's...
Yeah, he does look...
So he's got Nubs and he's a dwarf. Amazing.
Wow.
Without arms or legs...
Oh, no, I don't know, no fucking way.
I'm
he's got no legs either.
What? Oh. Maybe he's not a dwarf. He just don't have legs.
He's born with a rare condition, leaving him without arms or legs.
Huh.
He had to endure bullying. Well, yeah.
Well, sometimes dwarves have normal-sized torsos, so maybe it just...
He had to endure bullying?
Yeah.
The best part is, he's not the only midget that's at the thing either.
Oh, hell
the ghetto boys have one, too.
Oh, Bushwick's dead, though,
yeah,
ain't
he? Yeah, he's dead.
Is he?
Yeah, he got.
He died this year.
He died. Didn't his girlfriend shoot him, or he shot himself in the eye?
He was dying from.
And
something.
Lived, and then he got something else, and then died.
Oh, you mean his eye thing? Yeah, that was forever ago, though.
He got shot or something right in the eye.
Bushwick, yeah, Bushwick definitely died. In June.
He stood about 6 or 7 feet. That's a creep I've been seeing in my sleep.
He stood about 3'8".
Yeah.
But yeah, he died.
Now, Hoj, I'm not saying that this wouldn't be a great time, but I got to focus on the 80s cruise first and then Juggalo.
Yeah.
I got to be one. I don't know if my body can handle that much stimulation back to back.
How about the best of both worlds? You guys can go on the jam band cruise.
The jam band.
You want to do that?
Yeah.
Well, actually, Les Claypool.
So I can launch myself into shark infested waters to get out of it.
Well, Les Claypool has two bands there.
Okay. And that's the only two bands I want to see.
There's other people also there that I've never heard of.
Not going to go on a giant band cruise.
I mean, I'd probably want to see a little bit of what Les Claypool does, but other than that, no.
I wouldn't go on a jam band cruise even if they said Demi Lovato is going to suck you off all cruise long. I'm still not going.
That'd be a lot of chafing.
The fact,
again, chafing.
One of these bands is called Pigeons Playing Ping Pong. Like, fuck, I'd go. Or Les Claypool's Bastard
like,
Jazz.
Yeah, and that's, well, like, see, like, that, we could drive to that.
That's a couple hours. I don't want to drive that far.
Where is it in Indiana? Where? I mean, it's only 6 hours to Indianapolis.
It's
from here.
In an Indiana town on an Indiana night.
Oh, okay.
Oh, my. Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
Putting on a party dress.
So I've got to narrow down to the Monsters of Rock or the regular 80s cruise.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I don't know.
We'll make that decision.
They have one that's house music, like electronic music. Diplo's there.
I think, like, if I remember correctly, I'll have to look again because I might have been, because they didn't have anything in stone yet on next year's. But I think the way it looked was that you had to have like some kind of payment. It's like 25% of it or something has to be paid in like May.
So now can't you get on a cruise though like for $1,500 or $2,000?
Definitely like if you know there was definitely $1,500
tiers.
Yeah, I don't know what you.
We went on ours and we had a wicked room, like an ocean view.
Now, to me, my thought is, if we're going to do this, we should definitely get something cool. You know, I mean, because we're going to do it. We're going to share a room.
Cheap.
We're going to share a room, a two people. Yeah, you know, two bedroom. You know, it's going to be two beds. So we might as well like do something cool.
I really want to get Jeff and Morgan to go, so they got to share a room. And they'll fight the whole time.
Oh, that'd be sweet. Yeah. I mean, we might. I mean, I might even like bone up like half of like the cheapest one for them too.
So they can pay for them. We're paying for it.
Like
you guys just
shittiest go. Like boiler room, fucking bedroom.
Isn't Morgan
like
married now?
Yeah, he's not married. No. Yeah, and he regularly travels without her too.
Yeah, you got fucking Morgan on a fucking single cot, you know. And
oh god, can you imagine him on 400 pounds on one of them little beds? Jesus,
I think his issue is going to be fucking sitting on the toilet, man.
Yeah,
what are the toilets like?
I got to lose weight.
Fucking. I saw some guy come in on a rascal onto the boat, and you could hear people saying like, I don't know how that guy's going to use the bathrooms. And then I looked at my old lady. I'm like, that means something. And you go into the bathrooms and they're fucking tiny. It's like an airplane bathroom with like a shower in it.
Wow. Oh, you mean like in your rooms on the cruise?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, I honestly do not. I've flown probably 15 to 20 times. I have never used a bathroom because I've never flown more than like 4 hours.
I try not. Threw up like crazy.
When you flew out to Vegas?
When I flew out to Vegas. Cause
you got shit-faced before you went.
Yeah,
there,
I got. We were fucking hammered.
Yeah.
And then they let us on the plane as a joke. They thought it was like, you two are trouble, aren't you? And the girls are really hot. And they were like just being fun flirty, not like, I actually want to fuck you, but just fun.
Yeah. No, they actually wanted to
fuck. They thought we were just, you know, they just thought we were like just... Like,
there was no Mile High Club.
Yeah,
for
no.
You
and so I got on the plane, and then we happened to sit next to a power drunk business guy, and he's buying us all kinds of drinks, and he's like, because we were in like everyone around him.
I forgot about that.
So I'm like, he's like, here, dude, drink this. I'm like, dude, I can't. He's like, you all right? I'm like, no, man.
No.
And I'm like,
no.
And he's like, well, all right, man. Have the and I had a water real quick. And I'm thinking about it, and then it just hit me. I got to puke. I went in there, just throwing up. Man, I had the shakes and everything. It was so bad.
Yeah, I've seriously never had to use. Like I said, I mean, I've never flown any farther than like a 4 hour flight. So I mean, I never used it. You know? I mean, I've gotten shit faced on, you know, but I just never had to go. You know?
Yeah.
I mean, as soon as I got off, I've had to go, but you know, stumbling off a fucking plane.
Yeah, well. It was weird. Like when we arrived in Vegas, even though it's like because it was later at night, that was the emptiest airport. Like there wasn't many people in there. It was weird because you figure people come all the time. It just seemed like I went to their bathroom to throw up again when I was at the airport, and there's no one there, and it's like quiet, and I could just hear myself.
You got in like, kind of late at night.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
And then the next day, you and Rachel and Craig showed up, and I was still in. Pretty rough shape, but and I was Craig was there when I started hallucinating because I was like I was hung over really bad and we went for a walk in 120 degree heat.
Yeah, right.
And he's like, Mike, are you all right? I'm like, no, not at all. Uh-uh. I'm like, not one bit. Am I okay? Nope.
No.
He's like, you keep pointing at the same mountain over and over again. I kept going. That mountain looks weird, man. And I was like, Mike, let's go in the air conditioning.
<Let's go. laughs> I went down there a lot when I lived out that way.
Yeah.
It was only a 5 hour drive.
Yeah. Know? Yeah, it wasn't. Yeah, you guys drove down. Yeah. You been to Vegas or Hoge?
Yeah. I've never told you the story.
I knew your brother had been there. White. I didn't know that you had. I'm sorry.
No, we went for my birthday and we ran into.
Oh,
Dana
yeah, yeah.
White
you
and...
told me. I'm sorry. Yeah, you did tell me about that.
You ran into who?
Didn't tell me.
You didn't tell it on here, though, so tell it again, as you say in Canada.
Again.
My brother and I were fucking hammered, and we went down to Fremont Street, and we're in one of those. I think it was called the Golden Nugget. Uh-huh. I think it was called whatever one has the $1 million cash
That's
in like
Golden
the
Nugget,
keys.
Yeah, it's Golden Nugget.
Oh, yeah,
yeah. We saw him in there, and I was like, "Yo, is that Dana White?" My brother looks over and sees a bald guy, and he just starts laughing. He's like, "No, man, not all bald people look the same." And And I look back. I'm like, nah, dude, it's fucking Dana White. And he looks again, and it was him. And he's like, fuck, he's big. I'm like, yeah, he's a fucking big guy. I'm like, I'm going to tell that bitch he owes us money. My brother's like, fucking don't. Mine's already gone. And I was like, Dana. And he looks over, and he's got his, like, he's big. And his security guards were even bigger. And they, like, kind of, like, take a step towards me. And he's like, no, I want to hear this. I'm like, you fucking owe us money. He's like, what? Like, you fucking owe us money, man. We bought tickets for $7.50 each. Card was awesome. And it was the worst fucking thing I've ever seen in my life. We couldn't even sell the tickets for $50. He's like, you're from Calgary, aren't you? I'm like, fucking rights I am.
Yeah.
And he's like, we got some stuff in the works. And they announced that they're going to Edmonton like the next day, but fuck, he's a big guy, man.
Yeah, he's sizable. I saw him I wasn't that close. I was about 100, 200 feet away from him.
First time I ever went to Vegas was Memorial Day weekend 2000. First time I ever flew.
And, did you do anything interesting when you were there?
I partied with Wayne Brady.
Did you do anything else interesting?
Yeah. Wayne Brady.
The first time?
Yeah.
I didn't get married, but everybody thought I was gonna.
You did get married there, though, right?
No, we didn't get married there. Everybody thought we were, so basically they paid for me to do everything.
That was the rumor mill?
Yeah, well, that was the talk, but the problem was it was Memorial Day weekend, and when they say that you can get married at any time in Vegas, it's not necessarily true because they do close the courthouse on Memorial Day. So if you want a marriage license, you cannot get it.
So where'd you actually get married at?
We got married right down the street.
Okay. So I was wrong.
Like 3 months later.
I'll tell you what.
2.5 months later.
I've never stooped to prostitution, but.
That's a good way to start a conversation.
Some of them there in Vegas were so good looking that I was considering it. Like I'd get a little drunk. I'm like, you know what, dude? I'm not married. There's nothing immoral about this.
I was there with a dart league from Mothers, and like half the guys, or half the dart league were guys, and they were convinced we were going to sneak off and get married. So they threw me a bachelor party. They took me to Glitter Gulch, and I had literally every nationality. I had a black woman,
all of God's continents,
a blonde, a redhead, a brunette. And they were all like jamming big boobs in my face all at once. And one of them, I don't know which one, but one of them was yanking my crank like it was fucking like she was trying to get it to detach.
Nice.
And I'm like, okay, this is awesome, you know. But yeah, but Wayne Brady was there getting married. And he was there with his grandma. And
the Wayne Brady?
The Wayne Brady.
I
partied with him.
Did Wayne Brady tell a stripper that he was going to choke a bitch?
This was before Chappelle.
Wow.
About 3 years before.
This is like
Wayne Brady makes Brian Gumbel look, you know.
I mean, this is in the midst of Whose Line Is It Anyway?
Yes, it was in 2000, and he was gambling right next to us. And I'm like, I go, that's Wayne Brady. And there's like my now ex and then a couple other women that are part of the Dart League going, who's Wayne Brady? I go, you know, that show, Whose Line Is It Anyway? And they're like, oh my God, that's him, the one that sings. I'm like, yeah, his name's Wayne Brady. I mean, you know,
he has a name.
Like,
you know, yeah. Brady Bunch?
Yeah, and I'm like, so I walked over, I'm like, hey, you're Wayne Brady. And he's like, yeah. I go, yeah, they all know you from, you know, the singing guy on Whose Line Is It Anyway, but, you know, he was cool as hell. We did shots with him. He's like, yeah, I just got married today.
Sweet.
I was like, oh, that's cool. And we partied with Wayne Brady.
Yeah,
although, right, Angel was already wasted on 1800 Cuervo. So I mean, pretty much within 45 minutes of me hanging out with him, I had to take her up to the room. But I came back down, and they were still hanging out.
Wayne Brady,
yeah. I remember when we were in Vegas. I just remember you and Rachel. No matter where I went, or what time I woke up or went to bed. If I went to the bar by the pool, you guys were there drinking. You were at your height of your drinking. I was like, and if I was bored and kind of lonely, because the guys I was with, like, you can only run around in that wild pack so much. Like, I need a break. I'm just go sit at the bar.
Right.
I knew Al would be there. And I go sit there and relax with you and have a few beers.
Yeah, I'm not a big casino. Like, I don't like.
I don't gamble at all.
A lot of slot machines or anything like that. If I do, I play blackjack or something, but.
Mainly, I like sport book. I like betting on games.
You don't be able to do that here now.
Yeah.
One of these days, right?
It passed.
When?
She signed it.
Oh, okay. So she's not going to raise our gas prices 45 cents?
Well, they're still going to do that, but the sports book is going to happen.
She's such a bitch.
Yeah. You know, she's got some substantial boobs.
She does have substantial
boobs.
Dude,
that fucking blue dress she was wearing that day.
She looked banging, dude.
I was like, all right.
Ideologically, I don't agree with you on anything, but if I get to play with them,
she was.
I can accept a 45.
They had an event at the DIA for one of her family members, and she was there. And Danielle met her, and she said that she was showing off some cleavage while she was there.
Oh, yeah, dude,
she's fixing the.
Our governor's got some
too.
Nice-ins.
So,
yep. All right, yep. Mike sent me. Hoge sent me something here on Instagram. I'm sure it's going to be horrific.
Did you watch that Top Gun trailer yet, Alan? The one I told you about?
Nah. Is that what you sent me?
No, I sent you the Wham Slayer mashup.
Yeah, right. I haven't still watched
that. Stones had shared.
Slayer isn't retired.
So you know that there's a new Top Gun movie coming out?
Yeah.
It's called Top Gun Maverick.
Yeah. Gay.
Yeah, well, gay. I watched a trailer for it, and it has some striking similarities with the first one.
Yeah, we were talking about that.
Yeah, so, like, Maverick goes back to the Top Gun Academy to train people, and there's this one pilot who's straight by the book, and there's no one who's, like, a hot dog, and they don't like each other, and they fight, and they get into it. And then also, there's some hijinks that happen, you know, with the flying and stuff. Plus,
a volleyball
there's a shirtless football game.
Oh, man.
It sounds a lot different than the first one, right?
Yeah, it sounds way different.
I've never seen that movie.
I guess the big thing is...
I'm sorry that you're a communist.
Is it going to be, you can be my wingman anytime?
Probably.
Bullshit.
You can be mine.
And to me, it looks like this kid who's like the hot dog, the hot shot young guy who doesn't play by the rules is going to be like doing stuff, and Maverick's going to be like, whoa, I've never seen that before. And he's gonna be like the new Maverick.
Yeah.
It's a pretty predictable looking movie based on the trailer.
Who's playing new Maverick?
I don't know.
Nobody.
He played Mr. He's been in a bunch of stuff, but he played Mr. Fantastic in the recent Fantastic Four movie.
Oh, okay. I know the guy.
I wouldn't know that. By the way, I haven't seen any like Marvel or DC movies at all. Like
that's the one you should never see ever.
The only one I saw was like one of the Thors, and that was only because I was drunk with Sandra and her friend put it in, and so I saw it.
I haven't saw anything past. I think I stopped.
I did see Deadpool.
Yeah, Deadpool. I saw Deadpool. That was the last one I watched. Yeah.
Deadpool doesn't count.
I didn't watch.
I didn't think it did. That's why I was.
It does now.
I didn't watch Ultron or Endgame. I watched the first Avengers.
Deadpool because Gina Carano's?
Yes, of course.
I should have probably. I mean, I guess at some point I will watch the Iron Mans, and that is because I'm an RDJ super fan.
Sorry, I should have
been for 35
Brian,
years.
Brian, ask me the Gina Carano question again.
Are you a Gina Carano fan?
Of course I am.
That didn't work out right.
Are you a Gina Carano fan?
Yeah, I thought of course, but I forgot the I have part.
Oh. It didn't work.
Have you ever wanked it to Gina Carano?
Yeah. Of course I have.
That's right, Phil. Of course I have.
Yeah. Have you ever had a fantasy? Did you make a stuffed stuffed doll of Gina Carano?
A pillow,
make love.
You
to
see
it.
Though my favorite drop though I have on my soundboard, you can't hear it, Hoge, is fellow Albertan Cole Robinson, the Snake Diet. And
hey fatty.
Yeah, that guy's my favorite.
Hey fatty.
I love that guy. He does these hour long, he'll do an hour long live stream, Cole Robinson, screaming for an hour straight. Imagine no one, just one of us had to scream for an hour straight. And he's like, you need to lose weight, you fat fucking pig.
Yeah, just
and stop. And by the end, his voice finally starts cracking, and that's when he stops. He gets so mad. He goes, I'm going to have you fast. He goes, it's the easiest fucking diet in the world. You don't fucking eat.
Dude, when you showed me some of that shit, it was pretty fucking funny.
Hoge, you got to meet that guy for me. You ever go up to Edmonton?
I'll be in Edmonton next week.
God, you got to find him. That guy's my favorite YouTuber, period.
Find him.
You know, just a city of a million people. He won't be hard to find at all.
Yeah.
You're not a fat fuck, right?
No.
I was a fat fuck.
Because if you are, then he's going to pick on you.
He'll find you.
He'll find you.
You need to lose weight, oh yeah.
How many people live in Edmonton?
I think it's like 800,000, but in like the area, it's like 1.2 million, I think.
Oh, so it's a big suburban area like
ours.
Well,
I know that he works out at LA Fitness.
Do they really drive around on cars with square tires in Canada?
Fuck yeah, bud. Call snowmobiles.
Snowmobile.
Did you ever see a filming of Hell on Wheels anywhere where you live?
There's actually a bunch of shit that's filmed where I am.
Well, that's why I brought it up, because I know they filmed a lot of episodes of that show there, Hell on Wheels.
You're in Calgary?
Yeah, Hell on Wheels, I never saw them filming. When they were filming Fargo, I was living downtown, and I had to park in a parkade because the fuckers blocked off the road for like a month. Yeah.
That's not close to Vancouver, right?
No. Well, in relation
to the country.
Okay. All right. I don't know.
I'm a lot closer to Vancouver than I am to you guys. Yeah.
I don't know much about your land there. I was just wondering if you were ever in Vancouver and met the Winchesters.
Supernatural.
No. They filmed Wynonna Earp here. They just finished filming Jumanji 2. They filmed Ghostbusters.
If you drove directly south, you'd run into Montana, right?
Yeah, I could be in Great Falls, Montana. I think it's like a 4-hour drive.
Oh, well, Vancouver's like
West Coast.
Yeah, that's like Seattle. Like you, if you drive.
Yeah, that's above like Seattle, Washington State. Yeah.
It's like on. Yeah. That's probably what, 40 hours away from, or like
a long 11-hour drive.
See, like if I still lived out in Utah, like, and you drove straight south and I drove like kind of straight north,
and you get detained at the border.
Yeah, then we could meet in Montana.
Well, him and Phil are in the same time zone.
Yeah.
Oh, are they? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, they have time zones in Canada?
Oh my God.
Time zones were invented by Canadians.
You were so
racist
against Canada. Our neighbors to the south.
Our neighbors to the south.
So, MJ.
Yeah.
I bought a PS4 just to get Bloodborne.
I love Bloodborne.
I hope it's as good as you say.
It is.
Right now, I'm downloading Kingdoms of Amalur because you said it was good, so I'll give this another try.
That's fucking awesome.
That surprised me. You never played that before.
It's Kurt Schilling and Todd McFarlane.
All right, Salvador.
Kurt Schilling, the baseball player?
And Todd McFarlane made that game.
I didn't know that.
And R.A. Salvador wrote the story.
Uh-huh.
Todd McFarlane, that's like Spawn, right?
Yep.
Yeah. He's from here, too.
Hey, really?
What? Yeah, he fucking started drawing before he started working for Marvel.
Really?
Out of a trailer park here.
His trailer park.
So who do you think is Bret Hart the biggest, like if you think of someone that's like a Canadian, is he like the, like your example of like, this is Canada, Bret Hart?
Nah, dude.
Man, Wayne Gretzky would fuck
Wayne Gretzky?
More.
Okay.
Corey Hart.
Ooh.
Brian Adams.
Rogen.
Celine Dion.
Brian Adams.
Ted Cruz.
Terrence and Phillip.
Terrence and Phillip.
Ted Cruz.
Oh, yeah, Raphael. Okay. I don't know.
What about?
Hey, do you know Scott? He's a dick.
The Scott.
Most Scots I've ever met are dicks.
Look out for Scott. He's
a dick. That's right up there with guys named Adam. Guys named Adam are always fucking cunts,
too. Who the hell is Cody Coe? That guy was born in Calgary.
Do you know everyone? Do you know the guys from Letterkenny? Even though they live way closer to us?
No.
Like,
no,
yeah, they're from
don't.
A like small town in Ontario, probably 2 hours from here.
That show, man,
50
like
or 60 people in
it is so similar to small towns here, though. It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Hockey players are just right on the dot.
Oh, that hockey player skit, yeah.
Do you know Erica Durance?
No.
No? Okay.
No.
I'm just going to keep asking him. No.
She was on Smallville. She played Lois Lane on Smallville. She's hot.
Freaking. But the main thing is, before we get off here in a minute here, you got to promise me you're going to try to find Cole Robinson.
I'll definitely
get him to say,
down the window and
he say, I want and say, Mike from Radio Underground, you are a fat fucking pig.
You should call everybody in the show fat pig.
Well, I'm going to teach you how to fat.
Hey.
It's the easiest thing to do. Yeah, just go fucking eat.
Actually, well, yeah, just say, Radio Underground, you're a bunch of fat fucking pigs.
Oh my God, dude.
I want that quote.
We could retire.
I'll PayPal you money to get him to say it.
Oh my God!
Send him an email and be like, "Hey, can we have you fucking on our show?
We would be
get him up in here."
That.
Yeah, I want to get him on here like on Discord. Like, Cole, what would you do with me? I'm fat as fuck. What would you? How'd you start? You just don't eat.
Let's go fasting.
You fat fucking
pig. Real easy. You just don't fucking eat.
Just gotta tell him like, hey, our last episode had 205 views.
Yeah. His live stream
probably have like 100,000.
Yeah, his live stream probably gets. I think they get like 1,200 just on the when he goes live.
God,
it's insane. But all right, guys. I think
Are you watching The Witcher tomorrow when it comes out?
That's our. You already can watch it.
Man. Really?
Yeah.
I thought it was tomorrow. Fuck.
Oh wait.
Did they jip you Canadians on that?
Oh no, no. I thought today was the 19th.
Couple days difference there.
Yeah. I'm living in the past, but
it's winter here. Was it summer there?
It's a couple days difference. So I mean,
get all fucked up about the time zone.
Time zone.
Yeah.
Fuck you guys. I'm gonna text you spoilers of Star Wars when I go see it tomorrow.
Don't.
I don't care. You can text them right to me because I ain't never gonna fucking see that shit.
Fuck yeah,
dude. I'm only going to watch it so I can spoil it for people.
Shit here.
Yeah, the only person it'll affect is Brian.
Yeah. I'm only going to watch it so I can spoil it for people.
That's good. Cool. That's fine.
I'm just going to have to go see it, I guess. My wife's be like, you can't go to the movie. I'm like, I got it.
When people start talking about Star Wars, it's all...
Thanks for sending me to my grave with AIDS.
I'm going to tell everybody Baby Yoda's in it and he fucking dies.
Yeah.
I have no idea, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't care. All right, we're going to play River Bottom Nightmare Band to end the show.
All right, later.
You can find us on all social media, Radio Underground, Twitter, YouTube, you name it. Hoge, thanks for coming on.
No worries, buddy.
It's been Brian.
Hoge. Great Christmas episode we just had.
We talked about Christmas, not at all. Okay, we didn't talk about Christmas. We talked about suicide, people burning at the station.
Pedophilia.
My dad.
Alan getting swatted because a pedophile lived with him.
Yeah, Horsecock Al.
Horsecock.
And we played a Christmas song, but...
And we're going to play one at the end here.
Yeah.
My boss buying me a recovering alcoholic bottle of wine.
Yeah, we talked about why we stopped drinking.
But also gave you a hand.
But he also gave me a hand. But never anything really about Christmas, per se.
Yeah. Oh, well. All right, guys.
All right. Sorry.
recorded in the pits of Detroit, Michigan. Your ass is listening to Radio Underground.